really stinky.
Good morning. Good morning, folks. Here we go. Yeah! Portal, congrats on the first. Welcome on in, pal. Rebecca, I can feel it. I can feel how close you were. Feel how close. Better luck next time. Did I even turn on my mic? Yeah, I did. Okay, cool. I always do it. Like, I turn on my mic, then I turn on my camera, but I always wonder if I have actually turned on my mic in the first place. Food for thought. Blame your phone. Absolutely blame your phone. Molly, welcome on in. Lovely to have you in. Hey, Stinky Tutu, Dortle. Thank you very much. Hughes, I'm not looking at you, Rosie. I'm not looking at you at all. Welcome on in. Lovely to have you in here. And Maz, my lovely friend Maz, how are you doing? Welcome on in. Should I put a going live message in the Discord, maybe? We are here once again on... I'm touch typing right now. I'm not looking this. Fine Sunday morning. Ready to be taken by whatever takes us. This, I could have typed something entirely differently here. Pay a visit. There we go. I have typed it all right. I hope we're all doing well this fine morning. I did the thing that I don't usually do, which is I set up the like going live and everything like that. If I manage not to die for the whole day, I might fix my sleeping pattern. Best of luck to you, Rosie. Best of luck. It's a tough one to do. I thought I was going to be in a similar position yesterday, but I managed to sort it. Not to, like, rub it in your face there, but I really hope that you're able to do the same. Who do you think you are? I am! I love that video so much, so much. I quote it so often as well. Right, let's quickly post these going live messages. There we go. What was I saying just then? I was saying something and I completely forgot what it was, but it wasn't, I haven't got that. Oh, yes, I got my going live screen ready, and then I went off and started doing other things, which is unlike me, but I did it for a solid couple of minutes. My housemates have exams, so I'm trying to stay out of their way, and I was sending them some of my resources, so I hope they got them. Good luck indeed, yes. Rub it in my face, make me do it by spite, anything to get me through it. Then in which case, you're stuck. You're stuck with us here for this morning. We'll send you on somewhere afterwards, Rosie, and we'll keep you going for the whole day. I mucked mine up by getting COVID, but over it now mostly. That's good news, though, that you're back to normal. How are we doing? How How has our weekend been so far? Did anyone do anything exciting yesterday? Anyone got exciting things planned for today as well? I would love to hear about it. My day yesterday was interesting. Well, interesting because it was half a day. The half day I did have awake was brilliant. I spent it chatting to Tortle, which was brilliant fun. And my housemates, as I said, are back now, so I spent some time with them as well, which was lovely. However, I woke up at 12:30 p.m. So things were a little bit off schedule for me. But yeah, an exciting Saturday all the same. I got a puncture on the way home from the allotment. Tortle, no. On a bike? I'm sorry, pal, to hear that. Is it sorted now? Do you have like a puncture repair kit? That is a car. Oh, I feel it. Do you have a puncture repair kit for the car? Because I had one the other day. I was on my way to my placement and I was taking four other people in the car and I had a puncture on the side of a dual carriageway. Got the spare on. You have a spare tire. Okay, perfect. Perfect. Now, this is again another question. I'm going to open the lines. Do you have like a spare that is a permanent spare, or do you have like one of the placeholder ones that allow you to get to the place that gets you a new tire? I'm learning that there are different things. I just have a puncture repair kit, which is temporary until quick fit tomorrow. Brilliant stuff. Brilliant stuff. You're prepared at the very least, but it still hurts, I imagine. But yeah, goodness me. It is the worst feeling because you're like, there is nothing I can do about this. It's happened now and that's it, which really sucks. Highlight of my day, I went to work and then bought perfume. Very nice, Molly. What kind of perfume did you get? Did you get it from like a fancy place? I went into Lush on Friday and they have some interesting scents in there. Like, I think they have nothing but scents. Like, you go in and you're just hit by a wall. But I like it. I like it. I'm probably one of the few, I imagine, that quite enjoy going into Lush and just chatting to the people that seem determined to talk to you. It's good fun. Lassie, good morning, pal. How are you doing? Welcome on in. Lovely to have you here. How are you getting on? But yes, very exciting stuff. Tortle, sorry about the puncture. It really seems that the allotments come on quite well, though. I know I told you yesterday, but yeah. And also, very, very sorry, Tortle, about my mic quality yesterday. I worked it out later, and I was like, oh no. Oh no, I've done this all day. I'm so sorry. There was one thing I kind of wanted to show all of you. As well. It was fine. Okay, thank you. I started talking to my friend in the evening. And the first thing he said to me is, your mic's disgusting. And I was like, oh God, okay, great, cool, thanks. Nice to talk to you too. They're both by a brand called Voyage Royal, but in my head I was like, Voyage Royale. Voyage Royal. And one is called Conqueror, which is like vanilla and patchouli and cardamom. And the other is called the Pope's Daughter, which is very woody and ambery. Very nice. Those are some fancy names. Voyage Royal or Voyage Royale. Okay, let me get my... I forgot that. Is that the hotkey? Yes, man. There we go. Voyage Royal. Dracula Voyage Royal for women and men. For women and men. Bit limited, but which one do we want to click on? The 3.1 rating? Let's click on fragrantica.com. Let's click on Bloom Perfume UK. Especially excited about Conqueror because it's nearly an exact dupe for a $300 perfume and it only cost me $25. Okay, sorry, I just saw Fragrantica. Let's go. Wait, sorry, I want to see Dracula. Oh, very nice. Look at this. It's got your main accords there and a nice list. But that is a steal. Oh, it's over my face. That's me as my icon. Jackson, thank you very much for the resub, pal. Thank you. A good Sir Knight, Mr. Josh Monologue stream. Sir stream, let's go. Welcome on in, pal. Lovely to have you in here. How are you doing? How is the uni work going? Is it all under control? Fragrantica, is this like people resell it on here? Is that how it works? Voyage Royale. Royal. The Pope's Daughter and the Conqueror. Let's open those two. Oh, very nice. Look at that. Sweet Caramel Oud. What? Oud? It's a short neck lute type pear-shaped fretless stringed instrument. I use it to tell me what it smells like and what the notes are. That is very cool. I'm guessing this isn't what it smells like. What is an oud fragrance? Oh, it's tree-y. Wooden, I guess. Lactonic? These are saying some things. Lactones, yeah. Wow, okay, very cool. I'm ill at an inconvenient time, so the uni work is not going at all. That's a good enough excuse, I would say, Jackson. Sorry to hear that you're ill, and I hope you feel better soon. Warm, spicy. That's kind of cool, you know? Kind of cool. Those two bottles look identical. I'm not convinced that they're different. Oh, they're all the same. Those are all exactly the same. So usually if I see spicy, woody, or leather, I know I'll probably like it. That's a really interesting one. I was discussing this the other day about like different aftershave or perfume scents that I like. And it's amazing how different people can like them. Like I went searching for quite a while to find something that I like that wasn't like chemically smelling. There were so many chemically smelling aftershaves that I just couldn't hack them. I ended up getting something like floral, which was nice. I like the idea of smelling like a specific instrument. Yeah, I think there is definitely a distinctive smell to instruments. Like I had an old guitar that was passed down through my family, and that definitely smells of old wood. So I wouldn't want it as a perfume, personally. But to each their own. There was another thing that I wanted to go through with you all. Crow lines. I follow them on Twitter. Let's go in GBP. They have some cool clothes. Rebecca Rue, I don't know if you're here, but I think some of these would absolutely, you would rock these. Like, these are so cool. These skirts. Look at this one, hold on. Look at this. You are, look at these. These are wonderful. They're quite expensive. That is the downside. But they are some cool skirts. And also, take a look, hold on. That printed so cute, right? And look at all these. I want this so badly. So badly. Look at that. I love it. There, I keep looking at these and thinking how much I want them. Like, even this one's nice as well. I really like this one. Super cool. I have spent ages. The fish, yeah, it's so monologued coded, yeah. I feel like this would be good. Nostromo would rock this, absolutely. Very, very cool. The fish as a dress would be the best. Yes, I agree, that would look very good as a dress. I like this too, look at this. So I have spent ages on this already, and the little cats as well. This is lovely. I'm gonna keep clicking on everything, but yes, I really, really like them. I wear one that is discontinued, and I bought about 25 before it stopped being sold. That's brilliant, Total. Like, you stocked up on those. Monologued core, yeah. I thought you would like these. Rebecca, your outfits are always so, so cool. So I thought you would like these. I like this too. This would be something that I would like wear if I was in The Sims or something like that. But yeah, super, super cool. And they seem to be a really nice kind of person as well, from what I can see. Let me see what blankets they have. Oh, wow. Oh, I like the shark blanket. That is very nice. Very nice. Oh, thank you. I appreciate it. Mostly been in pajamas this week. You know what? That is completely acceptable. It's completely acceptable. Outerwear? What have we got there? Those are cool. Those are cool. Not my style, but they're still very cool. They do look cozy. You're right. You're right. I wanted to see if they had any, like, dinosaur-themed shirts, because I think dinosaurs would be very cool on, like, a floral or a pattern shirt. This, I thought they were Diplodocuses. Diplodoci? Can I say that? Fruity cutie button-up shirt. Very nice. Pajamas are the best clothes. If I could wear them everywhere judgment-free, I would. I wear a very interesting set of pajamas, and I realize what you're all thinking. You're all thinking, oh yeah, it's the nightcap and the striped pajamas. No, hold on, one sec. I don't have a button for this. No, there we go. That worked out quite. No, it's just stripes and then checkered and then like all sorts. If I wore those, I would wear them everywhere. I would. This one goes to you, Gangrene Dream. You're the one that's peddling this belief about me. No, I wear like anything that I could, so I definitely would not look like I should be wearing it outside if I did. But I think, you know what, if you're wanting to wear pajamas out, wear pajamas out. Did I click on stickers? Oh, very nice. Look at these. These are some nice little stickers. I would love to be the type of person that can stick stickers around. I am very bad, in as much as I feel bad if I stick the stickers down. My dear friend Wormliness sent me some bee stickers in a card, and I still have those bee stickers, just because I don't want to put them somewhere that I'll regret. Mouse pads? Oh, very nice. I like these like desk mats. Those are quite nice too. My pajama choice shocks most people. People would assume black like the rest of my wardrobe. They're pastel pink with penguins over them and a pastel blue top. I love that, Molly. I love that. Break the expectations. Did you say crow lines? Yes, crow lines. Here we are. Up there in the top, crow lines. Yes. I think I might have tagged you in one of their posts on Twitter at some point a while ago. I can send a link out to the chat so everybody who wants to have a look can have it. But yes, there are so many cool things on here. Sketchbooks, there we go. No worries at all. Yeah, so I'll be heavily thinking about this. The next thing will be Christmas, where I could get presents. Or if I have any money left when my next student loan comes in. So yeah, very, very cool, these. If anyone ever sees any, like, floral shirts or any pattern shirts or anything like that, I remember a while ago, Ian, tagged me. It was in The Swamp, which is Lelimo and Stromo's, Discord. And let's see if I can find it. Yes, there we go. And said, did you see Jonah Hill's really cool shirt? Which was, I appreciated that. Like, just out of nowhere, Ian was like, you're gonna wanna see this cool shirt, Mono, which I loved. So yeah, anyone ever sees those, send them my way, please. Just look at those. Just look at those. This one, I admit, this one is the one that I think is best. And I would love this. I'd also love to pose for that as well. That would be so fun. Do I have reviews? No, okay. I'll review it. I'll review it if they want me to. Hey, Crowlines, send it my way. Send it my way and I'll review it for you. But yes. Enough about that. I could spend a long while just looking at the same fancy shirts. So cool. Another thing I've been thinking about. Hold on. Pokemon Mystery Dungeon. I have been thinking about... I don't know if anybody knows Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, but it is such a fun game. That I used to play when I was little. Let's see if I can find the... we'll go for Blue Rescue Team. This was the one that I used to play when I was little. I think I've mentioned it a couple of times on stream, but I want to do a Pokemon Mystery Dungeon playthrough on stream. Because it has some good storylines, and I would like to go through those at some point. Please do it. I will. Because I always think, like, it would be really fun if I did stream Pokemon. But I play the mainline Pokemon games in a way that I wouldn't enjoy streaming. But these ones, like Pokemon Ranger, Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, Pokemon Link is an unappreciated, and I'm not underappreciated, unappreciated game. Pokemon Trozai is what it's also called, but Pokemon Link was so fun, so fun. It was just a linking game, like this, like you just, hold on, this is not it, that is not it. Maybe that's a new version. Give me original. That could have been it, yes. And you have to just link the Pokemon together, but the storyline was cool, the concept was cool, I really enjoyed it. This is there must have been a 3DS version that I just didn't know about. But yeah, storyline was super cool, and I really enjoyed that. I can't remember which one I played, but I never got far through it because I wasn't good at it. Is that Pokemon Mystery Dungeon? Yeah, so they have Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, Blue and Red Rescue Team, Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Explorers of Time and Space, was it? I imagine. And then they had the ones that came afterwards, which were like Mega Rescue Team or something like that. And then the one on the Switch, DX, I think it was. Rescue Team DX. But yeah, I didn't play those. I did the Blue and Time were the two that I did. And then you've also got Pokemon Ranger. Brilliant game. Brilliant game. Pokemon Ranger. This here, these characters. Hold on, let me. My head's in the way. I don't know how to deal with this. I do. These characters here, right? I love them. I absolutely love playing as them. This is the the boy character and this is the girl character. But I always wanted a Plusle. I always wanted a Plusle. So I would play to get a Plusle. And then Shadows of Elmia, I think I played that? What is this? Shadows of Elmia, maybe I did. I remember I played the first Pokemon Ranger, and then I must have played the second one too. But this cave here, yeah, I'll play Pokemon Ranger and then everyone will see why I'm so excited about it. It is lovely, like it's a very intense game. You can't, like, when you're actually playing, you can't kind of sit back and chill. But the music is so good as well. Anyway, very fun game. I remember this scene so well. Yeah, anyway, very, very, very fun game. I played one of the Mystery Dungeon games on DS, Time Rings a Bell. There we go. Time, sky, and darkness. Those were the three. This was my Pokemon era, to be honest. I played those two. So that's Time, Ranger, Shadows of Almia, Diamond, Platinum, and Pearl. I did play Heart Gold and Soul Silver, and I played Black and White a bit. I didn't play Black and White 2. This is wrong, r/Pokemon, as a matter of fact, because where's Pokemon Link? Where's Pokemon Link? Unappreciated. That's where it is. Anyhow. I stand by it. It is unappreciated. Another thing that I really liked about Pokemon was Pokemon Ranch. I loved this. This was on the Wii. And you could, like, upload your Pokemon from your DS onto the Wii. And you'd be able to, like, care for them in this little farm. Which was very, very cute. I've done Heart Gold, Pearl, Leaf Green, Emerald, and a tiny bit of Black. My dear lovely friend Abby likes Pokemon Black and White a lot. I think it's a very good game. Is Heart Gold the one where the Pokemon can... Or Heart Gold, Soul Silver, the one where the Pokemon can walk behind you? Is that the one with the Pokewalker? Because that was fun as well. Diamond and Pearl will always hold my heart because I started with Diamond. But I haven't played much of the others. I've played on PokeMMO. For those of you that don't know, PokeMMO is... Let's see if we can find a site for it. Can't? Really? Really? PokeMMO is a... Oh, there we go. It's the top one. It's just got a picture of it. It is like online Pokemon where you can basically battle with other trainers. It's an MMO for Pokemon. Very fun. It's quite easy to pick up and go with, which is good fun. Blue, Ruby, Black, and then I got into Black again during the Pokemon Go summer. Very good, Rosie. I like Pokemon Go as well. I liked it. I've been playing it recently as well, but not as recently because I haven't been walking as much because I've had to drive to places, which is dreadful, let me tell you. I used to walk to uni every day, and now I can't, which is sad. I think that was the first one with that. Oh, there have been more since. I see. I was on PokeMMO also. Very nice. I forgot about the Pokewalker. Yeah, I occasionally see some in CEX. Shout out to Nostromo. And I always think, like, should I get another Pokewalker? Heart Gold was my first and my beloved, yeah. I saw a post. Hold on. Here we go. This here. What your favorite Pokemon generation says about you, and it has all the different Pokemon games, and then it just has your age. So mine, Diamond and Pearl, you're around 23 years old. Fair enough. You know what? Fair enough. It doesn't even have Heart Gold and Soul Silver. You've been really, really screwed over there, Jackson. Well, welcome in, Jell, welcome in, Jell. I do like your monstrosity that you create when you enter the chat, Jell. It's wonderful. Diamond and Pearl is close enough, yeah. Well, it's somewhere between here. That's where it is for you, Jackson. Soul Silver was mine, yeah. So you had Soul Silver and Jackson had Heart Gold. I like that. I have a friend that I grew up with that had the, like, opposing games for me, and I would always set his name as the rival, and he would set mine as the rival as well. I distinctly remember having to borrow Jackson's starter Pokemon in order to beat my rival. Wow. You know what? That is sibling love. I love it. Another interesting creation, Jell. Isn't that wonderful? That's actually very cool. Yes, I did. I thoroughly enjoyed it. There was something else I was going to share. Ah, yes. I also, hold on. I would be interested in seeing other people's takes as well. But I was sent this link in the beloved Discord server I'm in. Here we go. This here is a website where you can make your own trainer card. This is the one I went for. Ignore the Volo from Legends. But this is my team that I would go for. If I could have, like, my own team. I probably, if I was genuinely, like, told to make a trainer for a game, it wouldn't be this. I would have a much more themed team, because I would be all about the flair. But if I was just going through and I had, like, a team, this would be it, I think. Lacking turtles. Turtle, make your own. Make your own, pal. You've got this. And you're right, it definitely is. But Cubone is my beloved. Plusle, I already mentioned that I love Plusle. Manaphy is the closest we have to a turtle here. Lives in the ocean. I think Manaphy's cute. And I remember Manaphy was the one that got announced for Diamond and Pearl. And it was so exciting, like, seeing everything happening when Manaphy got released. Carnivine, I think, doesn't get enough appreciation. They are a frightening looking Pokemon, but they are full of love. They are so full of love. Mawile as well is just very cool. What a concept. And Persian, I have a Persian on Pokemon Go. That's why. Take sheet off desk in my evil lab. Behold my creation. That is very good, Jill. I like that. How many? I'm gonna have to create something for you to monstrify out of my emotes. Is it based on vibes or actually having a good team? Just vibes, Jackson. Just vibes. I've never based a Pokemon team off having a good team. Just vibes. Hello, VB. Welcome on in, pal. Lovely to have you in here. How are you getting on? I just want to hug a Swinub. You know what? Mamoswine. Super cool. Super, super cool. Look at this, man. Look at that. So cool. In my idea. New Twitch emote genre. Yeah, monstrosity. Wow, Rosie, that is a good emote. I like that. I like that. Isn't there a Pokemon that is based on the description of an alien from a supposed alien sighting? Alien sighting Pokemon? Maybe Elgin? I don't know. That sounds very interesting, Vivi. If you find out what it is, let me know. Yeah, desperately trying to find the information again. Please, because that sounds so cool. Ah, yes. Sveal is my new love. Yes. I do like Sveal. Tortle, that is a monstrosity as well. I always think when Vern has the sunglasses on, I always think that he's, like, missing teeth. I always think, but... That looks almost pitiful, Gel, that one there. Like, it's just a little worm. The other ones are like the Julius one is quite frightening. Whereas the Hype Hide one, it looks like a little worm that just can't move. There's a website where you can put your favorite Pokemon of each type for each gen if you're interested. Say that one more time, Jackson. What did you say? I can put my favorite Pokemon for each type of each gen. I don't suppose also on this website I would be able to, you know, pick my favorite for each overall and my each legend and my favorite regional bird as well. I don't suppose maybe that would be what I'd be able to do. I don't suppose, you know. maybe. I bet it was Gengar. Found it, the Pokemon Sableye, introduced in Pokemon Ruby and Sapphire, is based on the goblins described in the event from the Kelly Hopkinsville encounter. Yes, that did show up very briefly there when I was searching. Lacking turtles. Turtle, I think you'll find that I specifically picked Tortuga with you in mind. And if we take a look here, we got Torterra, who is a tortoise. So, I'll have you know. Forgiven, thank you. But yes, so this is my run through. Most of my opinions here have been biased by a wide variety of factors. Yes, that does look like an apple, yes. A great choice. Turtle, you'll be pleased to know that my favorite Pokemon as a kid was Blastoise. Very, very nice. Very nice. I've moved from mobile to the PC to make a Pokemon trainer card. Brilliant stuff. Rebecca, please feel free to send that out in the Discord. I would love to see it. Anyone else who does the trainer card as well, did I send the link out? Yeah, I'll send the link out again for anyone who might have joined and wants to do it. There's a trainer card for you. Pokemon spreadsheet, you bet Mono is on it. You know it, Lassie. You absolutely know it. But yeah, I'll do a very brief summary here. So, Porygon, my friend, the one who I already mentioned today, the one who was like, your mic quality is disgusting. He loves Polygon. Porygon? Polygon's the company, Porygon. So I put Porygon, absolutely. Apom I just think's cute. Buneary I love. Skitty holds such a place in my heart. I'm surprised that I didn't put Skitty up top here, because Skitty would be it. Chimchar was my friend's Pokemon in Pokemon Diamond, like my rival, and he picked Chimchar. I like the Seer and Sage and Soak, is it? I don't know. Simi, Seer, Simi, I don't know. Pans, the water one as well, but evidently I don't like the water one as much as I like Tortuga. Milotic, I think, is very cool as well. You can't see my mouse. Hold on. How do I get like a pointer? Oh, you can see my mouse. There we go. Milotic's very cool. Obviously, Manaphy takes my heart. Glad to see Cyndaquil on the list. Yes, I do like Cyndaquil. I don't know any of these past the fourth row. I stopped knowing them about here, but I do have a vague understanding of Gen 8 even. Gen 9, I don't have a clue. But it did get to a point where I was like, what the hell is this? Why is Gengar so big? I didn't know any of that. Grass type, I think, was the hardest for me to pick from. I love Oddish. I love Sunflora. I love Cacnea. I love Carnivine. I love Pansage. This little fellow, I don't know who they are. Rowlet's cool. Grookey's cool. This, like, is it... I don't know what they're called. It's Gen 9. I don't know. That is a jumping castle with a tongue. Yeah, absolutely. Electric type is so cool as well. I love Shinx, Plusle, Sneasel's very cool. There's a Spheal for you there, Rebecca Roo. I did put a Spheal in. And fighting, I've always liked the like Gallade line, or the Ralts, the Curlier line. Very, very cool. Steelix was actually, I got a Pokemon card from my friend. And Steelix, it was Steelix EX, which I loved. So this was a hard one as well, because I love Cubone, Steelix, Torterra. Torterra was my beloved Pokemon from Pokemon Diamond. I had an Empoleon for one playthrough, and then I had a Torterra called Terraformer, which I loved. I was like 9 or something, I don't know, but I loved it. Cubone is indeed Bad Dad's Gel. I love Cubone. So, so cool. Onyx and Steelix look great. They do. They're really like... Onyx and Steelix. Can we get both up in one? Like, so cool. Such a cool concept. I really like him. Welcome in. Absolutely, Joel. Welcome in. Combi is definitely my favorite flying type of these. Abra, I have a cat named after Abra, so of course I'm going to like Abra. And of course, they're going to be my favorite. But look at that. What has happened to Girafarig? There. I remember back when Pokemon Go just started, running in the rain in the park to catch an Onix. I love that. That is very fun. That was what it was all about, you know. Can't remember if I caught. I'll check, please. Do you still have Pokemon Go on your phone, Joel? I do. That's not me going... You still have Pokemon Go on your phone? It's me asking if you do. Mana's cool. Dustox. I always liked Dustox for some reason. Again, well, I'm glad that I'm consistent with my favorites there. I have a Pokemon card that I picked up off the floor. Ah, hold on. This is even better. I'm good at this now. It's a cutie fly, which is... That's just going to be zoomed in on me there. This one here. Hold on, my mouse isn't there again. There you go. Cutie fly. I picked it up off the floor and I've kept it. Yes, I do like Mimikyu there. Mimikyu is very cool. Dusk Noir is on here from Mystery Dungeon. Yes, I do play it briefly every summer. Very nice, Jill. Very nice. Like Floor Spinach. Yes. Yes, Total. My Floor Spinach is growing, actually. I don't know if I mentioned that, but it is growing, which is quite fun. But yes, Ralts again. I didn't know who this was, but it was very cool. I figured I'd join in. Did I do it correctly? Let's take a look. Did you do it correctly? You absolutely did, Rosie. You absolutely did. Look at that. That's a team. That is a team. That is the kind of good team that you would find in a Pokemon game. Very good. I like it. What's Floor Spinach? Lassie. Floor Spinach. I went to a garden center and I found a pack of spinach seeds on the floor. And they had been run over by cars, but they were free, so I picked them up and I took them home and I planted them. So that's my floor spinach. There may be other floor spinach floating around, but that is mine at the very least. I love this, Rosie. This is very cool. I'm gonna keep that in the background there. But yeah. Seeds are quite expensive, so being able to get some off the ground was quite fun for me. Okay, my head is covering the starter ones. Let's zoom in nice and close so we can see all the... Still? Am I still blocking it? Oh, I haven't gone across far enough. There we go. Oh, come on, pal. You got this. There we go. So, starter. There's another turtle for you there, Turtle. Six Psyduck, they all know Dream Eater. Very nice. I like that a lot. Cyndaquil. Grovyle, again, is a Mystery Dungeon pick there. Piplup. Tepig was in a show. The Pokemon show. And I remember my friend talking about it when I was growing up. That's why. Fennekin, I just think is cool. Litten, I think is cool. Grookey, I think cool. The cat. It's cats hold my heart, really. But Piplup was my favorite, always. And then, look at this. What's up with the big Meowth? What's up with the big Meowth? I don't know who these are, but I think they're very cool. I have this muck in Pokemon Go. That's why I like it. I also have Perzerker in Pokemon Go. What is this? Dratini? Diglett? I don't know. I think it's cool. I just need to message my mum back. There we go. Cool. Just needed to make sure she was okay. He used to play with Tepig and Pixelmon. Well, if you're interested in Pixelmon, there is a new kind of one coming out. Maybe it's out already, called Cobblemon. I just looked at it recently. It's apparently like much more suited for Minecraft, which I think is pretty cool. Because I didn't like Pixelmon much, because I thought it was very like jarring. It didn't feel like Minecraft, which is why I play Minecraft. But yeah, like all the Pokemon really fit in quite well, which I think is quite nice. It's less restrictive. And you can also make new Pokemon species, add variants. Very cool, right? So if you're interested, check that out. I think I'm going to have to restart a Pokemon today after this chat. Which one are you thinking about, Rebecca? And then we've got the legends. So we've got Mew, Celebi, Deoxys, Manaphy. I didn't know that this was a legendary. I don't know. Victrini, are they? I think they're cool. I think there's Mega Kyogre, Meltan. I just remember seeing this one in the meme that's like, where do you work out in the library? Which I thought was very cool. And I guess that's a Mega Suicune, which I think is cool. And then Manaphy, of course. And then favorite overall, Cubone. Always will be. Always will be. These three at the bottom didn't mean much to me. I didn't know that there were different types of Spinder. Didn't know there were different Vervillains. I don't know what Vervillain and Alcremie are. But the Quick Ball definitely is my favorite. I love a Quick Ball. And Grass type, there we go. Bidoof and Starly are the Pokemon Diamond ones, that's why. And there's my team, which is backed up by not that, backed up by that, which is my team. I have an affection for Jinx because it was my first ever card. Yeah, isn't it funny that it's like that, Torthal? Like me with Steelix as well. It's lovely. Maybe let's go Eevee. Yes, good idea, Rebecca. Very, very nice. I have never played that. Morning, Steen. Welcome on in, pal. How are you doing? Can you believe in awake? I'm awake. I can believe it, Rosie, and you will continue to be awake until this evening when you'll sleep soundly. Very soundly. That sounded like a threat. I'm really sorry. I feel like you'd like Alcremie because it changes color depending on what sweets you feed the little one. That is very nice. Okay, yes, yes. I would be interested in that. I also want to hug a Snorlax. Yes, Snorlax. Snorlax is very huggable. I agree. I hope you're doing well this morning, Steen. Right, should I stop looking at Pokemon now? Very good, by the way, Rosie. If anyone else has any throughout, we'll throw those on. I'm going to take a very short be right back. A very, very short be right back. And then Discord, hold on. Let's take a look at that. Oh, yes. Yes. Oh, we've got some in there. Brilliant, brilliant, brilliant. Hold on. Let's get these first and then I'll take a short be right back. So, if you don't mind me sharing, I presume that people didn't mind. We've got Rebecca Roos here. Rebecca with Vulpix, Rowlet, Jigglypuff, Eevee, Spheal, and Stuffle. What a team. I feel like we would be a very good, like, duo battle here, Rebecca. Like, we've got cute Pokemon, and that's what matters, really. It's just cute Pokemon. I think this team could take on anyone, absolutely. Jigglypuff is adorable, yes. Yes, I agree. God bless Pokemon Go, but I wish there wasn't limits on storage. Makes my life so miserable. Yes, it is dreadful in terms of that. Like, you can get your storage up by just doing gyms, but it's so difficult to do. It is such a bother. I can't afford Pokemon Go. Isn't it funny? It's free, Steen, but it still doesn't feel it, does it? It literally makes you spend money to advance. Yeah, I have not spent a single bit of money on it, but it does try its damnedest, doesn't it? I basically play Pokemon like it's a petting zoo. You would have loved Pokemon Ranch. This is Jarathorn's trainer card. Cyndaquil, Ralts, Piplup, very good. Turtwig, very good. Diglett, very good. Alakazam is the odd pick there, but still very good. I love it. Very, very cool. And you've got the approval for Turtwig. Very, very nice. Spoons. Spoons. That's fair enough. And then we've also got... We have Tortle's card. Hold on. There we go. Hold on, hold on. Squirtle, Wartortle, Blastoise, Torterra, Turtonator, Turtwig. Very nice. Very, very nice. I love it. Nothing if not predictable. Hey, if you've got a brand and you've got to stick to it, stick to it. I respect it. I think, you know what? Tortuga should be getting a place on here at some point. Get a second team on the go, Tortle. Just fill it with turtles. I love it. Very, very nice. Item bag is full away and F off. Very nice, Joel. Yeah, it's such a pain. Like, and they give you so many random little items that it really doesn't matter. Right, okay, I will be back very shortly. I've nearly been live for an hour just rambling about Pokemon, so I'll be back very shortly. Rosie, don't go to sleep yet. Don't go to sleep. Stay awake. Stay awake. I'll be back. Catch you all in a second. See you very shortly.
Wow. I practiced by playing our armor.
You're sickeningly good.
Oh, thank you, thank you. That's many, many hours of being stuck in a cave practicing on the bones of those around me.
I can very slowly play Rugrats.
Lengthy message. Hobo for a lengthy message. What a load of shite.
Whoa. What the fuck? No scope. Did I pin him to the wall?
I love you.
Love you.
Do you have a favorite Jason Derulo song, Mono? I feel like that is a quite a loaded question, Danger.
That too is the sound I make if someone picks me up. Ow!
Is 33-year-old Judith Glaslow.
They
just finished playing this game and just gone to bed and was streaming it. And I was like, I was just picturing, like, in the friends section of Twitch, everybody sort of scrolling down and just seeing me just watching someone sleeping. And I thought, I really don't want to give the impression that I'm sat there watching someone sleep stream. But anyone who looked at that point would have probably thought that's what I was doing.
Astromo loves a sleep stream.
I got very anxious about it.
Nostromo absolutely loves the sleep stream. I am back. Hold on. Let me catch up on what I've missed here. Oh, flip! Oh, that really jump scared me, to be honest. Oh, sorry. Sorry, folks. Thank you so much, Torthal, as always, for the shout out clips. My neighbors are having a roaring match already, wasting no time today. Steen, started early and finish it late, pal. That's how we go. That is how we go. The Jason Derulo Dark Souls arc was a whole vibe. Thanks to Danger for that one. And shout out Clive to Danger. I really miss the Nostromo streams. And I was watching the... I went through the Clips channel in the Swamp like a couple days ago, and I was just watching all the Nostromo clips. I regularly rewatch their anniversary clip highlight as well. Nothing like a morning with monologue to start the day right. Hello all, welcome on in, pal. How are you doing? Lovely to have you in here. We've just been going through Pokemon teams for about an hour, like saying our ideal Pokemon teams and stuff like that. Great fun. Great fun. Ah, we've got one here. Hold on. From Jen. Jen, I hope if you're here, I hope you don't mind if I pop this up on stream. Hold on. Josh Scare, yeah. The trailer is so good for Nostromo. Everything Nostromo put out was so good. I'm good, how are you? I'm doing well, thank you. It's been a week off for me, so it's been catching up on chores. I still forgot to phone my mom. I'm sorry to my mom. I just phoned her now, and I will be phoning her later. But here, let's take a look. Hold on, where's my... There we go. This is Jen's, posted in the Discord. We got... I feel like this is very cool. Corviknight, Umbreon, Gallade, very cool. Frontliners. Scorbunny, very cool. Lucario and Luxio. Luxio is an interesting one. So you've got Shinx, Luxio, and Luxray. And Luxio is the middle evolution. I love Shinx, but Luxio is very cool. Corviknight, thank you, very nice. Welcome in, Gel. What have you been up to, Ree? How have you been getting on? Corviknight looks so cool, never seen it before. Yes, I think it's like, is it Murkrow's evolution? Maybe. Very cool, either way. I can't bring myself to make a trainer card on the mobile UI. Do you want me to do it on here and we'll go through it, Gel? We've got time. How do I make my own? Make yours now. Sorry, Rosie, I'll get yours back up. Gel, what do you think mine would be? Wow, okay. I have to decide for you, Gel. Okay, so we've got Cubone in here. Let's stick Cubone in because you said that Cubone was bad dads, which is very cool. You've been putting a lot of Gengar in chat. Let's see, I'm gonna try and analyze the messages that you've sent out. You've put a Charizard in there. I think you're just putting Pokemon in there. You ran to catch an Onix. That's effort that you've put in there to catch an Onix, which must mean that you want an Onix in your team. What else have we got? Not Pokemon Go. Pokemon Go is not in your team. Right. Now let me think of Pokemon that I think you would like. Let's look at a full list of Pokemon. Hold on, let me go through in my head. What Pokemon do I think are very Gel? Well, Gel is very good at music. So do we go for like a music Pokemon. Which music Pokemon are there? Loudred? Wismer, Exploud. I think Loudred would be cool. I think Loudred would be cool for you, Jill. Just rolled out of bed. Perfect, Reed. Take your time. This is the chance to wake up nice and easily. I do like Loudred. Very nice, very nice. Trainer name, Jealous. Trainer Carter title, Jealous. Okay, what else have we got for Jell? Jell is a notoriously good hillbilly and blight, so about moving very quickly. So if we're to go for that, can we do a Deoxys speed type? Speed form Deoxys? Let's go for that. How are we looking? Cubone, Onix, Loudra, Deoxys. What else could we go for? I like that there are just like egg. Should I give you one? Go on, Jill. Go on. We can work together on your Pokemon card rather than just me. Let's work together. Shiny Galarian Ponyta. Galarian Ponyta. Shiny. There we go. Look at that. That is one cool looking Pokemon. Chansey. 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 Egg. Chansey. Is this Jell's team? This is what we've got. My prized Pokemon Go possession. That is very cool. I like it. Now let's pick a trainer for you, Jell. Who would you like? N is a very cool character. Barry will always be my rival in my head. I don't know who I picked. Did I pick Volo? My other one that I really like is elite trainers. I love the ace trainers and stuff like that. Let's put you as an elite trainer, Jill, if you're okay with that. And then background, let's pick a nice background for you. Pokemon anime? Well, I don't really want just Ash lurking in the background. Let's not do Pokemon anime. Let's do Pokemon Masters. Sure, and we'll pick that there. There we go, Jill. So I'll save that and I'll send that out as your card to the Discord. Jell's... I'll at you as well. Jell's card. There we go. So now I rate it. 10 out of 10. Okay. For Cubone. Thank you. Thank you. Onix, 8 out of 10. I'll take that. That's a win in my eyes. There's so much choice. There really is, Rui. Loudred, 7 out of 10. It's going down, but I'm still taking it. Still taking that as a win. Deoxys is going to be a low pick. It's going to be low. But, you know what? There we go. 4 out of 10. Hey, that's winning in my eyes. Galarian Ponyta, 10 out of 10. 11 out of 10. Jeez, look at that. Look at that. And Chansey, 9 out of 10. Hey, we've not done badly there. On average, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. Deoxys was a pick for me. I like Deoxys. We've got a couple more to look through, if you don't mind me sharing them. We've got... Why is it doing that? We've got Molly's here. So, Swinub, Snorlax, Jigglypuff, Mimikyu, Eevee, Shaymin. Shaymin, very good. And we've gone for Hedgehog form Shaymin as well. Very good picks. Very, very good picks. Snorlax is very huggable, isn't he? And Cynthia as a trainer icon. Top tier pick as well. Excellent work. Thank you, Jill. I'm glad to have your approval here. Rhi, I think there should be a link in the Discord if you did want to do it. And you can also make it at pokecharms.com if you're interested. And then we have Maz's card, here we go. Oh, this is a very good card, hold on. So, for Maz, we've got Sableye. Let me get the... There we go. Sableye here, which Vivi has already said. Alien sighting. Ampharos, incredible pick. Incredible pick. Altaria, also very good pick. Mousehold, which is, I think is a new Pokemon. It's just a cool concept, really. Gastrodon. Yeah. Gastrodon, it's a pick that you don't see often, but very nice. And Klefki, another underappreciated Pokemon. People don't like the inanimate object Pokemon. I really do. And Maz, this is a perfect trainer pick for you. Very, very cool. It's a family of mice that beat Pokemon up. I love Mousehold. And the name is brilliant too, as well. Yeah, I agree. Swinub just reminds me of Winnie when she sleeps. We own a Swinub. That is very sweet. But yeah, very, very cool. Everyone has such cool teams. I love this. Oh, what's happened there? Here we go. I can't leave the house without my keys. Very nice. Just made a hilarious Pokemon joke in Staggy DBD Leaks chat. Hold on, hold on, hold on. Very good. So, DBD Leaks. Haley Gold Frappuccino put a leak, like a water leak. Gel put Farfetch'd, the Pokemon that holds a leak, or a spring onion, or a leak. But very, very cool. Right, cool. Should we play a game or something, maybe? I wasn't sure if I was going to play a game, and maybe I shouldn't. Maybe I should just carry on talking. I'm quite enjoying this. So maybe I'll put a game on a back burner, and I'll keep talking for a bit. There are so many more I wanted to add, because I just remember loving all of them as a young lad, to your team card. Yeah, that is the difficulty with it, isn't it? Like, if I was to make a team of, like, electric-type Pokemon, I could do that quite well. Like, Plusle... I'd put Shinx in there. Look at my big card of... Where am I? This me? Download? There we go. I'd probably put Pichu in there as well. Emolga. I think I could do it. Grass, I could do it with no hesitation at all. Off topic, if you haven't played RE4 Remake, I 100% recommend it. It's very good. It does look very fun, and you can play as Leon, which is perfect for me. RE4 Remake. But it's quite expensive, isn't it, on Steam? 60... That's quite expensive, but I would want to play it at some point. So maybe when the price drops a bit. It only just came out, yes, that's correct, yeah. Leon from Leon, exactly. Leon is also a Pokemon guy. Look how stupid this fellow looks. I love them. Look at this low resolution image of this guy in shorts. Yeah, costs a little bit, yeah. I understand why. But... a bluegrass band containing only Pokemon as the members. Gel, very good. I'm going to have to do some research. Bluegrass music is a genre of American roots music that developed in the 1940s in the Appalachian region of the United States. You play in a bluegrass band, is that right, Gel? What does it consist of specifically? Like mainstream country music, it largely developed out of old-time string music, though in contrast, bluegrass is traditionally played exclusively on acoustic instruments and also has roots in traditional English, Scottish, and Irish ballads. Okay, fine. So it's acoustic stringed instruments and emphasizes the offbeat. Very nice. I like that. I play in a jam, yes. I've watched your videos. Gel on the swamp, and I like them a lot. Shorts with tights is a choice. I saw him while trying to pick a trainer. Yes, very, very cool. Jell, I will start this, absolutely. This will be something I will finish off stream, because I'm going to put in some solid effort on getting the exact vibe right for us in which Pokemon has which instrument. Let's go window capture, add existing, paint. Can we... There we go. It's just got my head hidden. Hold on. Hi. Google Chrome. There we go. So, Jell, do you have any preferences as for Pokemon that we're going to put in this band? I'm going to write up at the top so I can think about it. Let's think. It consists of how many people? If we have a team, we'll have six. But I think at minimum, we can have four, maybe? We'll see how that goes. We'll go for... every time I see Appalachian, I think Appalachian Mountains, and if you heard your name, no you didn't. Spooky things happen there. That is a reference I don't understand, but it sounds pretty impressive. I think Appalooza, which I think is a thing from The Sims. Appalooza, maybe? It's a horse, yeah. Which is in The Sims, which is in the Sims 3 Pets, and that's how I know it. Appalooza Plains or something like that. Dreadnought guitar, resonator banjo, double bass being plucked, fiddle, dobro played on its side with a slide and finger picks, F-style mandolin. Am I genuinely nailing the pronunciation? Because it's terrifying if not. Yes, okay, thank you very much. Okay, so the Pokemon we're gonna go for here, Cubone. We're gonna do Cubone. Are these the instruments that we can pick from, do you think? Or is there, are those in your jam session, Jill? Mm-hmm. The violin, also known as the fiddle, five-string banjo, guitar, mandolin, upright bass, the resonator guitar, referred to as the dobro. That looks cool. Oh, is that the company? It still looks cool. Harmonica? Or Jew's harp? Mouth harp. That's pretty cool. Okay. You can do vocals as well. So we could have someone on vocals. Or are they all on vocals as well, maybe? Yeah, those are like all the instruments typically played in bluegrass. Okay, so for Cubone, what's Cubone going to have? Finger picks. I think probably dobro, which is the resonator guitar, right? Dobro. We'll go for that for Cubone. I think if I did pick Galarian Ponyta for you, Jell, it would look like I was trying to draw My Little Pony fan art, and I don't know how faithfully I can do that. Where did I put... There we go. Onyx was an okay pick as well. Chansey was an okay pick. So let's get Chansey in there. I used to play Jaw Harp years ago. Do you still know how to? That is very cool. I think I mentioned recently that I wanted to play harmonica again. Which is very cool. So, Chansey. We could have Chansey on... I think Chansey on a Dreadnought guitar would be very, very cool. Like, hold on, let's look up Dreadnought guitar. Okay, it's the type of body, but Dreadnought just sounds very cool. Like... Let's have Chansey on the Dreadnought guitar. My one broke the tragedy to end the reign of Jell. Ensure that the dobro is held in the right way, played on its side with a slide and finger picks. Hold on. Played on its side with a slide and finger picks. Let's see if we can find a picture of it, just so you can confirm for us, Jill. Dobro bluegrass. Like this?
Don't spend £6,000 on photography accessories.
Folks,
this £85 drone is all you need to completely transform your photos and videos.
There we go.
This state-of-the-art drone is designed with the most advanced nanotechnology.
Brilliant.
This drone will allow you to access breathtaking landscapes.
Oh yeah.
And record in full HD unique moments.
Well, that's what I've been looking for.
Any type of vibration.
No vibration?
Of it, anyone can use it.
Me?
All you need is a smartphone to operate.
This is it though? Orange Blossom Special, there are better examples song-wise. This is cool! I'm sorry, this is super cool. Is someone else doing the background like duh, 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 duh? I can hear the offbeats, if that counts for anything. I've always wanted to try one of these. I've seen them at the local guitar shop. This is so, so cool. Yes, please, Jill. I'm captivated right now. That bit's so cool, like... I spend a lot of time on YouTube watching Wolfpack videos, which is like jazz funk. But I just love watching people enjoy the music that they're playing. How cool is this, man? If I get DMCA'd for it, I don't even care. I don't even care. I'll just mute it out in the VOD with me kind of going like, and doing my own interpretation of it. I could do it. How cool is that? Tablature is available at Greebooth Dobro. Don't do it. Don't do it.
£85 drone is all
what?
You need to completely
really?
Transform your photos and videos.
No.
This state-of-the-art drone is designed with the most advanced nanotechnology techniques.
Seriously.
This drone will allow you to access breathtaking landscapes.
Tell me more.
In full HD,
what about the shaking? What about the vibration? No vibration?
Anyone can use it.
Anyone?
All you need is a smartphone to
operate wow.
it and you can give free rein to your creativity.
Okay. Let's get... Hold on. Tony Rice, calm down. Calm down, pal. Dear investors, what happened there?
But to act on it,
mm-hmm.
you need to get out of your comfort zone. With Grammarly Go, you don't have to take that leap alone.
Sorry, are you advertising AI to me? Grammarly Go brings AI to every text. No!
Helping you produce high-quality writing in a fraction of the time.
No!
That means no more overthinking email replies. No more waiting until tomorrow.
You are having me on. No chance.
A partner that can help you take the steps to achieve your ambition today.
Amazing.
No.
Grammarly Go helps give you the power to.
You're just picking that. You're like, ah, you know what? I'm not even gonna read it. Submit.
Ways to grow. Click the blue button to download Grammarly Go today.
No. No chance. Off. Off. Or just don't, yeah, get that AI trash out of here. Absolutely. Cheers to that. Is this the resonator, the Dobro? Grammarly is actually an okay one for checking punctuation and grammar. Sure, absolutely fine. But not for to write your adverts for you. Please hire me to edit, yeah. They look pained whilst they're singing. I respect it, but... I love the fact that they just walked around to start singing like that. Why are they leaving out the Dobro folks? Wow, they're going for it. Is that a mandolin? I can kind of play that break. That is very cool, Jill. I have a mandolinist that I've seen before. I hope the Dobro person gets a solo here, because this is what I'm needing to see right now. But of course, it is a Volpec video that has... I love it! He just appears out of nowhere to start singing. I can't remember if he does in this one. Devastating, devastating. They don't make him like they used to. I tell you what, tell you what! And they don't. It ain't the same these days. Welcome on in. There we go. There we go. That was the little solo that we got there. Portal, I told you to bring another two mics. They're just gonna get like closer and closer together as time goes on.
Use bullet points in a presentation. Look. If you are responsible for driving new sales into a business you own...
If you're responsible for driving new sales... This is what I've been doing wrong. Here, I've got all the presentations ready for everyone, and they've all got bullet points in them. And this is why I can't release them. Blame this fellow. He's the one stopping you from seeing your presentations. Yeah? What do you do instead? Just don't do them. Just don't do them. Just don't actually, don't show anyone them. Loving their coordination, I agree, Ree. There's a vibe surrounding old microphones that I can't quite describe, but I like it. Yeah, it's like, it does sound like Fallout music to me, but that's just how it is. I was going to show you two things. Give me, this is the one I want.
Try this 3-minute shower routine to quickly get rid of toenail.
Right, okay, we're skipping this one. That was gross. I didn't. Targeted ads, Tortle, that one's not targeted. That one isn't. The PowerPoint one, yes, that's not. The dude that gets left out in the singing looks like an NPC in the background sometimes, must be very concentrated. I'm sorry, folks. I skipped it as quick as I could. You absolutely should use bullet points in a presentation. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, Jell! Yes, it is! Tony Rice on guitar, basically the Hendrix of flat picking. I watch this weekly. I'm sorry, folks, that I'm sharing this with you, but this is Theme Town by Volfpeck. It's actually sped up slightly, which you can tell by... Hold on! Ange, can you DM me the link to that thick toenail remover asking for a friend? Thank you very much for the resub, Ange. No, I can't. Can't do that. And you can't even watch the VOD because it's going to be DMCA'd. I'll do it. I'll send it to you. The mandolin, man. If you like bass lines, Jackson, listen to more Volfpeck. Have you considered a position as Volfpeck's marketing manager? Hey, I'd snap that up in a heartbeat. His facial expressions here are incredible as well. And it's so clear that they're just enjoying themselves, which is so fun. Like... They also do... a live at Madison Square Garden performance, and Chris is there as well. Going for it, man. Anyway, I watch this like weekly. I love it. I will play that in a second. Yeah, right? And this is Joe Dart on bass. And he always goes for it. I guess at this point I'm like, well, we may as well watch the full video at this point, right? Like, we've got this far. When it brings it back to this. And everyone in the background's clearly just enjoying it too. I told you to bring 5-stroke t-shirts. Oh, brilliant. Yeah, I'm sorry, I could genuinely listen to that constantly. Like, always having a good time when it comes to that. The trouble is, none of you live with me, which is fortunate for you, because my housemates hear this regularly. I play music in the kitchen constantly, with their permission, and they have to put up with all this kind of stuff.
What if you could do SEO smarter and faster?
Is it going to do AI?
Your meta tags, page by page, or all in one go.
Okay, no more AI. Thank you.
Modify your URL.
Thank you. We're good with that. Thanks. Right, okay, folks. I'm going to mute it. Ange. This one's for you specifically. Just for you, Ange. Just for you. There we go. Cool. Lovely stuff. This one's definitely gonna get DMCA'd. I'm gonna get struck here. That bassline is reminding me of Miyavi's guitar playing in his earlier days. Please drop any links of those. So, sorry, Jell did say something about this here. Nickel Creek have been around for decades now. Progressive bluegrass, I think, the name of the genre Nickel Creek are. He can sing as well. I would just love to be in a in a group like that. Like, I can't play very well, but I would learn if it means I can sing with others. The Doraemon figure in the background. This is nice. I like this, Jill. That's so fun. Yeah, I really like this. I really like this. This is so fun. What is that in the background? Is that a cello? I like that the singer has this viola or violin and is just not playing it. Very, very big fan of that. Yeah, I will get DMCA'd, yeah. But hey, this is an exclusive stream for all of you folks out there. We can't do any Outer Wilds gameplay today, because it just will not get through to YouTube, which is the key place. Could always restart stream if I wanted to play it later. That's a good shout, Tortle. I'm actually really enjoying just chatting and listening to music, to be honest. But that is a shout. If I do think about that, I'll go for it. Wow, fair play. I love the different harmonies. I sang in the choir for a bit at uni. I've definitely told the story before, but I'm not a singer in the slightest. Go on, now the violin's in prime position to be played now. I'm not a very good singer, but I did it for one term. And the, yeah, go on. Very good. I like that. Very nice. Very, very good. I like that a lot. Yes, I played in the choir for, I'll just sort all of this out whilst I'm doing it. I sang in the choir for one term. And, at the end of, like, the term, everyone got their, like, Christmas cards and stuff to say, like, thanks so much for singing. And it was like, to this person, your singing's beautiful and you make up such a key part of the alto section. I got, Josh, really appreciate your enthusiasm. I was like, cool, yeah. That's a way to say that maybe I shouldn't be in the choir. So I didn't go back, but I did enjoy it quite a lot. Enthusiasm, you know, I've got it. That's about it. Right, where are we? Here we go. How cheeky, I know.
Ice water flushes 67 pounds of fat.
Apparently.
People are flushing away.
Right. Whoa, okay. That really jumped out at me. Different genre entirely, but bassy as hell. Very nice. If I'm gonna definitely get DMCA'd, I'll only just stick to the bassy part of this and then I'll be like, okay, cool, we can come back to it. But I like the sound of this too. Yeah, slap bass, that is it. And that's what Joe Dart does. Yeah, that is very nice. I really like that. I think there's a slap bass Wolfpack tutorial now? Yeah, here we go. A month ago, Joe Dart put out, Joe Dart teaches slap bass. I haven't watched it. Your YouTube ads are absolute hot trash, my word. And it's because I've successfully managed to get rid of any kind of tracking on me where possible. So this is, it's all completely random. Or in theory. So it's giving me that kind of stuff. It's not because I regularly, this is, I'm clarifying, it's not because I regularly look up toenail fungi or ice cube fat loss or AI grammar techniques. I don't do that. I promise. Please believe me. Please, you have to believe me, Ange. Please. I don't do it. Or I won't do it again. But yeah, very, very cool stuff. Let's see if I can find the AI toenail fungi from Grammarly.com. Exactly. All of the ads in one. Volpec MSG. There we go. That's what I want. Don't know which part it is.
Are you someone who lives and works in England and Wales?
Well, no.
Of over £6,000 you can't afford to repay.
No, but hold on. No. Which bit does Chris come in at? Here we go. Oh, that's Antoine Stanley. There is a part where Chris
Dealey.
There we go. I knew where it was. This is such, I watched this entire concert at home a couple of weeks ago, and I was in a state of euphoria. Like, it was incredible for me. So this is Smile Meditation. It's from Thrill of the Arts, I think. And if I could recommend it, this concert was incredible, in my opinion. I know that is because, as Tortle says, that I could be Volpec's marketing manager. But I had such a good time watching this. My, Oh! I love it, I love it. And it just looks like they're having so much fun with it, which... My mum won a TV a good few years ago, maybe 10 years ago? No. Yes, it is a mini Sax. It is. And the TV now is broken and it's got lines going down it, but we can't buy a new one. But it just made the experience so much more fun watching a concert on this TV with lines going down it as well. Yeah, so it's the mandolin, which is tiny, and the mini sax, which is also tiny. You can hear the crowd singing along to the music, which is what I do as well. Piccolo sax, I imagine it probably is, Joel. You'll know more than me. As a slight side note, I plan on buying myself a MIDI keyboard sometime soon. Yeah, look at that, they're loving it. Maybe even as soon as I'm free from COVID. Very nice. I'm so glad, Ree. I'm converting you here. They're just having such a fun time. I really like it, like... Just that. Mm-hmm. How can you do it that quickly? I love it. It genuinely does. They are just vibing here. Straight back to it. Straight back to it. I love it. Sorry, I was getting caught up in that there. Like, I know nothing about non-strung string instruments. You still probably know more than me, Jill. So good, right? So good. So good. I like musicians vibing or vibing with musicians vibing, exactly. This doesn't seem like a show, just some people vibing with their instruments while other people cheer them on. The best thing about this is that because a lot of Wolfpack songs have no lyrics, it is like they can have the people in the audience sing along to the music rather than the lyrics, which is really, really fun. Like, I think at the end they mention it. I won't spoil it for Fuel, but like they mention how it's hold on, let's get how it was great to hear people like talking, like singing to the melodies as well, which I think is so, so cool. I'm glad that you're enjoying it, Reed. This is great. It is a magical feeling. This one, I think this is what I'm looking for here. Might be towards the end of this. Anyway, this is a very fun song. The amount of instruments and how they produce different and unique tones, even the same instrument, but built differently, is so fascinating to me. Especially thinking about how someone had to come up with it. Yeah, instrumentation. I would wish I get the opportunity to play more instruments, and I will continue trying.
New York, New York, thank you so much for coming out tonight. This is a special night for all of us.
I'll just play this a little bit more. Bear with me here, folks. Bear with me here.
You know, when you do a concert like this, we were just talking about this before the show. We get so much joy from doing this. But the truth is, this really isn't about us. This is
typical
about
concerts. Blather, you know? People who go to Polyphia concerts cool do that too. They sing along to guitar stereos and it's hilarious. Yeah, exactly.
I'm saying that because I know that
if
I
this
personally know
doesn't
people,
convince
you,
know
what I mean?
If this is the part that I'm thinking about, I'm hoping it is the part. If it doesn't convince you to watch at least one more Wolfpack video, I've failed my job here.
Which means a lot of you took planes, trains.
Okay, yeah, we'll skip forwards. I've done this part. Yeah, good. Okay, fine, good. I believe. I hope so. Nope, this is a lovely speech. You can watch this in your own time. Maybe it's not this part. Hold on. There's definitely a part where I can check in the comments for it. But anyway, very, very cool. Useless time codes. Perfect. There are some very incredible parts here. Incredible parts. Um, I don't know where it is. I don't know where it... Ah, here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Maybe. Oh, that sounds pretty intense. Yes, here we go. This is it. Right.
I'd be happier to have it in the World's Greatest Arena. You know what I mean?
I'll turn it down briefly whilst I do it. That's the fun part about MIDI keyboards. You can mess around with so many sounds, but just on a little keyboard. Not exactly the same as learning the instrument, but still. I would love to learn the instrument, but yeah, I get what you're saying. I've been loving making orchestral sounding things without knowing anything about how to play one of the instruments. Oh, that sounds pretty intense. They just do a G.
And it's in tune, yeah!
Like...
I knew we had a musical crowd tonight.
Back Pocket's a very good song. And I can't find the...
You guys are such a great audience.
Actual part.
You've been singing along with so many words, so many bass lines. We haven't even asked you to do that.
There we go.
You're doing it so graciously. I thought I'd invite you to sing what I believe is one of the, if not the most complex, three-part sing-alongs in the history of humans. You guys down for that?
I think this is the part. If not, watch it all. You'll find it.
What was my G again?
Okay, here we go. I cannot imagine how cool it would have been. How cool it would be.
Sing it. The middle's gonna go like this. Put it in my bucket, put it in my bucket, in my bag pocket, put it in my bucket, in my bucket, in my back pocket.
To get your crowd to harmonize on something. That's a lot of faith in a couple of thousand people. And it sounds good! Right. Anyway, I'll stop it there, but so cool, so cool. I love it. I was captivated by it when I watched that. Of course I was joining in as well. Yeah, so cool. I would love to be able to get to a level where I can improvise like gel. The stuff that you've been putting in the Discord has been great. Like watching you kind of go for it with the jam group that you're in. Incredible. Incredible to me. I've just seen this here, Ree. Ree's trainer card. Also brilliant. Look at this. So, very cool trainer. Got Pidgeot, Psyduck. Just one Psyduck, not six, like Rosie's. Dewgong is an incredible pick as well. Look at that. Ursaluna. I've never seen that before. But how cool does that look? Ursaluna Pokemon. Is it evolved from Ursaring? Evolves from Ursaring in Hisui. Very, very cool. I've only ever played Pokemon Go, so mainly went off Pokevibes. That's what it's all about. That is what it's all about. That's exactly what Pokemon's all about. Licky Licky, very nice. And Unknown is very good. Where am I? Put it in my pocket. Very true, Jill. Bluegrass is all about improv. Irish less Scottish, less so. That's fine. That is the fun of it. I'll need to post a vid from the Bluegrass Jam. I don't think I have. That you don't think you've posted? Yes, please do. My dad ate my dad's Pidgeot. Is this true, Ree? So sorry. Total. I think I've missed this, but I'm okay with it, and that's fine. Don't eat Pidgeots. But yes, Ree, fully support this, and I like the trainer card too. That's the Legends one, I think. Super cool. I love this. Love it. I love that everybody's posting it as well. Like, these are some lovely, a lovely collection of different people's cards that we've got here. We'd make a wonderful team. Where was I? Oh. But yes, also Gel, thank you very much for sharing the bluegrass thing. I will get that drawn for you. That'll be an off-stream thing, because I'm gonna have to do some bluegrass research to get everything entirely down. There was one more Wolfpack song that I'm gonna show you, because.
Meet Grammarly Go.
No. You've tried your pitch, pal, and you failed. You failed. So this is Rango 2. It is Rango is the first one, and then you've got Rango 2, which is like building on Rango. The thing I like about it is if you listen closely to the actual Spotify song, you can hear it, but you can see it here. You can see it right here. A dog! And you can hear the dog walk past in the song, which I love. I just love it. Grammarly, go in the bin, am I right? Very good. Very good, Ree. This is one of my favorite Vulpec songs. Look how much the bassist is going for it. And they're loving it. They're loving it. Hold on. I could play more of Rango. Rango's great. But this is another instance of people. No. People loving. So pleased with it. You can see how much. Look, watch. And you can hear him. You can hear him enjoying it so much. Go back, listen. I love it. That was the first Vulpec album I listened to. This was Mr. Finish Line. Incredible. Really incredible. And it hooked me. But look how much Charles Jones is enjoying it. Like, you can hear him laughing and, like, he does it and looks across to, like, the rest of the band, like, okay, that's the one, we can wrap it up there, which is perfect. I love it. I love it. Casually just have an organ at the back of the room there, yeah, absolutely. It's also what I love in some rock and metal, when the band members just get into it and vibe. I think that's what music's about, right? Like, just having fun. Just having fun with it. I don't know, that's, for me, that's what it's about. I think, yeah, I will get to the point where I can do that, for sure. For sure, for sure. That's so exciting to me. So exciting. I genuinely love the live at Madison Square Garden so much, like, absolutely, absolutely loved it. Oh, it's incredible. Hold on, let's get the casual music back up. When Molly and I went to see I Prevail, the clean singer Brian was such a hype man and would dance around whilst Eric did his vocal thing and the guitars were popping off. That's what it's about. Do they not tour in Europe? I think they have in the past, Tortle. But they don't tour much, I don't think. Let's see. Vulpec tours. I don't think they do tour that often, which is, you know, fair enough, I suppose. Manage preferences, reject all. Yeah, just America. They definitely do. So there's an offshoot of Volth called Fearless Flyers, and they. So this is Joe Dart, who's the bassist, and Corey Wong, who's the guitarist. And they, yeah, here we go. They've done a video, Fearless Flyers. No. Right, you're gonna get told that you're inappropriate. It's dangerous content. It's misleading or a scam. Email. I'm not putting in an email. Submit. Really, man? Provide additional details. It's scamming people with unhealthy tips. Email. Change your ads at email.com. Submit. Yeah. Wonderful. The singer also did a shoey, so, you know, pass the Aussie vibe check. What is a shoey? And you're still just gonna play the ad, even though I've just told you it's inappropriate? Pal, come on now. So anyhow, Fearless Flyers live in Europe. So they definitely have toured around Europe. I imagine they went to... They've got Amsterdam and Paris. They must have gone to London too, right? Right? Anyway. But yeah, I would love to go and see him. It's when you drink beer from a shoe, right? Yes. I've definitely heard of that before. Thank you, Vels. Yes, he did. Eric is an honorary Aussie now. Very nice. You get a shoe, pour an alcoholic beverage of your choice in said shoe, then chug the alcohol. I don't think that's too bad, you know? It definitely could be worse. And yes, now Wolfmon is also, like, the director of Wolfpack is also making music. So I imagine they'll tour at some point? The shoe has usually been worn for a couple hours at this point. Flavoring? Maybe? A dude did a backflip in the mosh pit and got to do it with him. The shoey as well. It was so fun to watch. That sounds like chaos. The only, like, rock or metal, I guess, concert I've been to is Tenacious D. And it was relatively tame. No offense to them. Relatively tame. But it was enjoyable all the same. Mm-hmm. Some dude just... okay. Now that is worse for me. Threw his shoe on stage. Like, I'd be fine taking off my own shoe and doing it. Someone else's shoe? I draw the line there. That is not for me. Thank you very much. Goodness me. No, I'll pass. No, not for me. I wonder... I'd love to learn some of these things. Anyway, concerts are entirely my thing. Entirely not my thing, maybe. But that was one that I would have been really upset if I'd missed it. Yeah, I can understand that. I really like concerts, personally. I when I listen to music, I tend not to listen to the live versions because the music that I typically listen to is not one that is able to be done live, if that makes sense. Like, it's more, you'll hear it and you'll be like, let me put my face up big. You'll be like, okay, yeah, this is good in terms of, like, production value, really, really cool. But it's not got many instruments. But since starting listening to Wolfpack, I've appreciated live music a bit more. And I really enjoy concerts anyway. So when I have been to a concert, I've loved it. Disclaimer, by the way, I've never done one and I don't plan to. Then you're not a real Aussie, right? That's how it works. I love concerts, but I need to buy myself some hearing protection. Yes, I remember when I used to go to concerts with my parents when I was little, and I was little, and they would give me, like, earplugs to put in, and I think that should be done more. Hold on. Whilst I'm on the topic of, concerts and music that I've listened to, this is what I was raised on, this kind of music. So, for those of you that don't know, my parents are South African, so that is kind of how my music taste evolved when I was little. I'm going to see Ghost in October, and I'm so excited for it. First time they're touring Australia ever. Ghost is very cool. I do like Ghost. I also saw someone describe Ghost as if Scooby-Doo chase music was metal. Make of that what you will. So this is Johnny Clegg and Savuka. Johnny Clegg sings in a mixture of Zulu and English. If you get the chance, I've recommended to Gangrene Dream a lot of Johnny Clegg's music, and I believe that he listened to it. If you get the chance and you've got some spare time, check out some of the stuff, because like, this music is what I was raised on. This and Mango Groove, which I'll play in a second. And it was wonderful to watch live on stage. I've seen it 3 times, I think, live on stage. In Hyde Park in London, there was a celebration for Nelson Mandela's 90th birthday, and I went along to that, and Johnny Clegg was performing there. But yeah, proper, like, this is what... this sounds awesome, like sunny day making breakfast, good vibes music. Yeah, some of them are quite deep and tell a story as well, which I guess most of them are. After seeing the music from it live, I've convinced Dad to watch Inception with me, so I'll be lurking for a bit. If I'm not here before the end, thanks for the chats and the good vibes. Glad to have provided today. But yeah, check this out at some point, because Johnny Clegg's super cool. Mango Groove. I actually can't spell when I'm streaming, like, it goes out of my head. Let's go for Penny Whistle.
Try this 3.
No, flipping hell! Jeez, pal, get a grip! Lord almighty. Oh, I've got it muted, whoops. If there's one more of that, that's it. That's it, no more music. So this was the kind of stuff I'd listen to as well growing up. I have a playlist with my friends on Spotify. Yes, no worries at all, Molly. Enjoy Inception if you're going as well. I know, Rosie, I know. On my actual browser, I have an ad blocker. So, this one doesn't have any lyrics, but I've made it clear that I like that. So, for those of you that don't know, this is a penny whistle. So, that's the name of the song. It's very fun. Yeah, anyway, very, very cool. So check them out as well. Special Stars, also very good. I have a playlist with two of my friends that is kind of a combination of our music, and it is quite jarring when you go down it, because you'll have like some Fall Out Boy song, and then you'll have Penny Whistle by Mango Groove, and then you'll have like Nightmare by Avenged Sevenfold in quick succession. And if you're listening in order, that is genre whiplash, but very fun. I think that's what it's all about. I could share music all day, because I evidently just love it. Thank you very much, SK. Get that badge. Get that 100 badge. I don't know if I have one different. I hope I do. I hope they do. Are you up to it? Are you there? SK, welcome on in, pal. How are you doing today? Lovely to have you in here. I think Tortle, I should be fine. There you go, SK. Get crowned. Hello, Mono Gamer Logs. We have not been doing a single bit of gaming today, SK. Let me put the music back on. We haven't done any gaming, so I'm sorry to disappoint, but we might be about to after a very short break. I think I should be fine. Right? I don't know how getting DMCA'd works, but if I, like, do now no more music, I can just crop it, right? I can crop it. Is that right? Anyone cite me on this? I come back and then two hour, 8 minute break. Yeah, my bad. I'll crop it for a video upload. I think what I'll do is instead of going for... Okay, perfect. Thank you. Did we do like marker? Is that right? Marker. Finished? There we go. Right, maybe? That works. We'll see how that goes. Yeah, so I'm going to go for a break. Thank you, Tortle, very much. And when I get back, I think I might do some Baba Is You. Outer Wilds, as much as I'm loving it, I do want to dedicate time to it because it takes me a long time to get everything done. So I think we'll do some Baba Is You, if you wouldn't mind sticking with me through that. So we'll take a short break. I need a pee. If you haven't had a pee, if you haven't had breakfast, if you haven't had some water, get yourself some of that. Pop back shortly. I will see you momentarily. Catch you soon. Baba.
You can't have fucking ladies misbehaving. Do you know?
Look out!
In the shadows of my life, I've been watching, I'm waiting on Kirk. Will you hurry up, you dick?
Thank you. Yes! Let's fucking go, baby! Oh.
I've not heard of either, but I'm sure they're good. Oh, take me through a pallet.
Yes! Whoa!
hate that!
His body so he doesn't have to lose it. There we go. Interesting also because I get to see how people like to arrange their stuff. That's first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Whereas, because of Minecraft, I always put torches at the end, and this tends to be where food is, or bandages. That's melee weapons on one, which I guess is not...
Hello, hello, I'm back. Thank you again, Tortle, I can always count on you, thank you very much. Twitch are already at the door trying to bang it down, telling me that I've been playing too many music clips on stream, so... I've been holding them off from you all, don't worry, they won't reach you, you're all good, you're all good. It's just me, I'll take that hit. Right, okay. Steam. I haven't even loaded up Steam yet, that's where we're at right now. We're gonna do some Baba as you. I agree, Maz, Baba. Set game, thank you very much, Total. Thank you. I imagine it's done it. There we go, perfect. Thank you very much, Nightbot. Appreciate it. Thank you, Total. If you didn't know, I don't know if it's still at the moment, Metro Last Light Complete Edition is free on Steam. Death Stranding was free on Epic. These are all things that you, too, could get for free. Baba. Is this right? Let's move me across to here. There we go. Hey, Baba is you. Okay, continue playing. So, we started Baba as You at some point last week. And we spent our time puzzling our way through it, with the help of Maz as well. So, bridge building? Bridges? I forget what we did. That's right, we used the bridge... Okay, hold on. So, I think what we do here... is we have to make it so rock is me. Ah, right, hold on. Let's... Oh, I've nearly killed myself. We need to... Ooh, okay. Okay, hold on. We need to push rock and rock next to each other. So that we don't lose... Okay. Oh, I need to now undo rock. Ah, there we go. Hold on. Okay, think that's fine. Now we need to make rock push again. Hold on. We can undo. This is going to be me for the rest of the stream, folks. It's going to be me going, I think we can do this. I think we can do this. Maybe we can do this. Should we try this? So now we need to make rock push again. Push rock. Then make rock not push, and we've got a bridge. Ah, oh, flip, it doesn't work like that. Okay. Rock is float, text is float. Rock is float, we don't want rock to be float. Baba is rock. Rock is you, can we do that? Oh, no, we could just do rock as you, and then flag as win. Flag is not float. Flip. Okay, hold on. You sure you want to restart? No, I don't. Let's go back. Okay, we need one rock over there. Alright, now that we're in the gaming part of the stream, I need to talk about it. I played the Barotrauma tutorial the other day. I have a strong feeling I will sink you all. Brilliant stuff, Lassie. I love to hear it. Who did you play as? What role did you take? Very, very exciting. I was talking to Torkel yesterday about how excited I was to play Barotrauma with you all. Very, very excited. So... Please, please do let me know. Okay. Hold on, folks. I think I'm getting somewhere with this. Bubba is you. Rock is Win. We'll get there in a sec. How did you destroy the water the last time? Can you not do that again? I think it's because it was float last time. And we're not floating this time. Can I push? Can I make flag as push? Hold on, let's try that. Flag as push, maybe? Let's undo. Get it all lined up. Flag is push. Rock is you. Oh, Baba, careful. Flag is push. I don't think I was meant to do that. Have you gotten the hang of it already for total? Don't worry, Lassie, the tutorial isn't all that helpful in telling you how to play. That is true. That is really true. It is kind of a baptism by fire. I tried everything except Medic, which I still have to try. Medic is quite a tough one. I think you can do it. I think you can do that. Which is the one role where you can do the least damage? That's a tough question. That's a really tough question. You can do damage as the captain, because you can hit into walls. You can do damage as the security guard, because you tend to have the guns. You can do damage as the electrical engineer, because you can blow up the wiring. Maybe mechanic, but you can still do damage as mechanic if you try hard enough. Assistant as well. Medic, you can definitely do. I'd say medic, you can do the most damage as. Reverse damage in theory, but not always in practice, Tortle. Worst case, I just lie down and stay out the way. That is the fun part about it. But no, Lassie, you're going to be such a key crewmate. Which did you enjoy the most? Did you have one that you preferred? I was asking Tortle this as well. Flag is when we don't want it to float, is what... is what's key. If we could get rid of the float, then. Can we bring Wynn back across? No, no, that was a mistake. There we go. Wynn is across here. Bubba is Wynn. Bubba is Wynn doesn't get us to Wynn. Stop! Okay. Okay, cool. There we go. Bubba is you is Wynn. Does that work? No, that doesn't work. Rock is Win doesn't get us to where we want to be because we can't touch that. The only other thing we can touch across there is the flag. The flag is floating, is not floating. Everything else is. There we go. Okay, not medic then. Sure. Engineer seemed all right. Engineer's good fun. Mechanic and engineer are very good fun. If those are your favorites, like, we can have multiple of a type in a crew, which is absolutely perfect. Like, if multiple of you want to do the different things, then that works out wonderfully. How do I do this? I'm trying to make it so I have access to everything here. Rock is you. Oh, not yet. Let's get everything set up first. Another is. And we need Win as well. Rock is you, Rock is Win. There we go. There we go. I knew it. I knew I could do it. Another one? No. Cool. Look at that. I've just been playing with AI, so I've mostly been captain, but I do like being security. I figured for the sake of when we play Barotrauma together, I could go for Captain, unless someone has particularly enjoyed Captain, just so that everyone can get a chance to play the different roles that they want to do. Security is very fun. Our security officer in my home playthrough, Chaos. Text is float. That removes any chance of win. Cog is push, right? Let's push cog. I see what to do. We push. No! Bubba is you, water is sink. Cog is push. Bubba. I feel like I've botched that there. No. There must be a way I've been missing here. The cogs turn together. I hope you can bear with me. Lassie, not even. We will be reveling? We'll be thoroughly enjoying your company. That's what it is. It's nothing about being good or bad at it. Nothing at all. You have all of our words about us. And if people are not giving us all that, then they're not on the team. That's what it's all about. Me and Steen, at least. I'm not new to it, but I am excited to play with you all. Ah, here we go. There we go, folks. There we go. Oh, flip. Well, now I'm in trouble, aren't I? That wasn't what I wanted at all. We do want text to be out the way. And then I knock win out the way. There we go. And then we can push it this way. There we go. Then we push. Ah, flip. Oh, we need win back up again. Hold on. I pushed win too far down. Come back up. There we go. By the way, in this corner you can see... Oh, flip, wrong one. Oh, what? Oh, do I have a paint tab on game screen flipped? Let's hide that. There we go, cool. So you can see in the top, water is sink, Bubba is you. Cog is push, that's what we're doing here. Lassie, you'll be absolutely perfect. I'm excited to have you aboard. There we go, text is win, and we touch anything. Can we... Water is win? Can we do that? Or Bubba is win? Can we just Bubba is win? There we go. Ooh. There we go. Ooh. Whenever there's a question, where's Lassie at? I'll be running against a wall thinking it's a door I can't get to open. See that wonderful stuff. I look forward to it. The doors and stuff are a bit chaotic. I often find myself when I'm playing Captain, I kind of do like a check and I'll be like, is everybody still alive? And if I don't hear a response, I do go looking. So don't you worry. Really wish the doors were automatic. You can make them automatic, Steen. Did you have a role that you enjoyed playing, Steen? Okay, we don't want that. Is a robot gonna have to just die? Robot is stop, robot is you. Flag is win, pipe is stop. I die. I need to become me. Did I get myself at an angle before somehow? There we go. That's an angle. But now Bubba's not me. Bubba is me because I can push Bubba as you across to this side and become me. There we go. Nice and easy. I was saying to Steen, the one and only complaint I have against the game is that I wish there was an ability to set a key for opening doors rather than a mouse click. Yeah, that's a really good shout. So, like, you don't have to click the button, you can just automatically press E or something and it'll open it, like that. Yeah, I'm not really a keyboard and mouse kind of person, so that adds a nice layer of challenge too. Are you able to connect a controller to it, Lassie? I don't know if that would help you. I didn't really stick to any job in particular. I did like steering the ship as tough as it was. Steen, if you're wanting to be captain, pal, take the wheel. Take the wheel. I got it on the Steam Deck. Yes, you mentioned that, yeah. Bubba is you. Robot is move. No. It's gonna just get me. There we go. Yeah, get stopped, pal. Scholars defeat, Piper stop, win. What if I get the robot to keep moving? Where's he gonna go? Back across. Back and back. Okay, back and forth, back and forth. Can I... there must be a way to do this. This will be interesting. I think a controller with that kind of game doesn't make it easier, unfortunately. I'm sorry. Yeah, that is possible. But I will manage. I just wanted to set expectations for the crew. Lassie, my expectations remain high in a good way. Don't you worry. Midge found an alternative way to do this to what I did. Okay. Well, okay, whilst we're toying with the idea, let's just start experimenting. Okay, no. Hold on, can I use the robot as a buffer? Oh. Can I make robot me? Oh, hold on. I've got it, folks. I think I've got this. Robot is move. Break it. Robot is you. There we go. Now back down. Oh. Now I'm kind of stuck with robot is me, but that's fine. Robot's gonna die. Go on. Keep pushing robot away. There we go. We got robot out. Trouble is, I've definitely done it wrong because I need Bubba not to be so low down. Can I just have to push it down? That's all I can do. All I can do is push it down, which is not ideal. But yes, Lassie, you're absolutely fine. We will be rocking and rolling together. Sorry, folks. It'll take me a little bit to work this out, but when I've got it, you rest assured that it'll be the most miraculous thing that you've watched. Okay, you ready? You ready? Robot is Bubba. Win. Oh, Bubba, down. Real Bubba, come up. And then we go. I was panicking there. I thought I'd botched it. Bubba is. Is win. There we go. There we go. Tortle, was that the way you did it or the way that Midge did it? Or was that an entirely new way? Okay, eight, let's go. Midge kept the robot, okay, and you became Bubba. Bubba is you and open. Water is stop and shut. It was worth a shot. It was just worth a shot. Flag key. I had to rage quit this yesterday, Rebecca. Tortle and I were talking about this. Yes, understandable for sure. Was it one level that I had done? If you wanted a hint, you're more than welcome to have a hint. If you didn't want a hint, you're also more than welcome. Key is you and open. That feels risky. That feels very risky. Yeah, I'm still in the lakes one. There were some very tough ones in there. This feels very risky. I feel like I'm gonna doom myself. Can I? Why did I not think of that? Get Bubba down there. There we go. Bubba is you. How has this benefited me? Bubba is you and key? Key is you and Bubba? Did I do that? Ah, because Bubba doesn't exist anymore. Cool. Key is you and flag? No. No, we don't want that. Bubba is you. I don't know. Me and Jellyfish are not pals. No, absolutely not. Jellyfish was a tough one. If you do want to hint, Rebecca, I'm more than happy to help. More than happy to help. Let's put flag as me. Flag is now me. Ink you, very good, because we're talking about jellyfish, and jellyfish are similar to squid. Maybe? And it wasn't a typo at all. Can we... Hold on. Am I overthinking this? Can I do that? No, I can't. Yes, that's what I meant, and not that I was distracted in typing. Absolutely not. So I need to get it. So these items, when I am them, I can kill. I can break things and they go. Bubba is you and open. Hold on. Can I do... Bubba is open? Hold on, folks. We're going to restart. Okay, let's get this down slightly. That's as far as we need it down. And then we'll put open here. and then put E here. No. May I ask what cereal mixes were had today? You may indeed, Tortle. And you know what? I have been waiting for this question. Today's cereal mix was 3 Wheat Biscuits from Tesco. It was then followed up by Tropical Granola. It was then followed up by Malt Wheats and then Corn Flakes on top, with some oats as well from my oat milk. But the Tropical Granola, I splashed out £2 for a kilogram bag, and I've been looking forward to it. Incredible, incredible. I had a dream yesterday when I woke up at midday that instead of Tropical Granola, I put in sliced carrots, and it was enough to wake me up to get me to get the cereal, because I didn't want it to be sliced carrots. Very exotic, I know, Steen. I know. It was a nightmare. Coconut flakes, I don't believe so. It has, like, maybe mango chunks. I don't even know what's in it. I just know that it is sweet, like properly sweet. It's very nice. Yes, the cross tactic, Maz. I'm trying to work out how to... Oh, here we go. If we do this, and then I can make E is U. This is a shot in the dark here, folks. Right, well, we didn't want to do that. We wanted to make flag is U, really. Because now there are 2 flags, so one of them can die. We also need flag is open and hold on. Okay, here we go. But yes, did anybody else have cereal today? Did anybody else have breakfast today? What did you have? Please let me know. I'm curious. Whilst I'm puzzle solving. Here we go. There we go. Nice. Now we push win out of there and we put flag is win. How do we get Bubba? Flag is you and win, maybe? Are you winning, son Lelimo? Yes, I am indeed. And you saw it firsthand. Firsthand. Welcome in, pal. We're not doing Outer Wilds today, Lelimo, because I want to dedicate time to it, and I spent 2 hours just chatting. So I want to do more Outer Wilds in a burst. Cheese and tomato on toast in the air fryer, one of my favorite breakfasts. Oh, Rebecca, that sounds lovely. Do you put like paprika and stuff on it? Because I can imagine that would be very nice. That sounds very, very nice. Lelimo, I hope you're well. I love you lots. Steen, I've had a banana. Very nice. Very, very nice. Tortle, did you have anything so far? Was it a classic Tortle breakfast? Just salt and pepper today. Very nice as well. You know what? That works wonderfully as well. Research facility flipping. Heck. Bolt is push. Skull is hot. Bubba is you. Wall is stop. Win. Key is defeat, bolt is melt. What am I waiting for? As Gwen Stefani would say. Bolt is move. Ah, okay, so we put bolt in place and get bolt to move. No, that's not how we want you. How do we get you in there? We want you to face that way. Oh, flip. A scrambled egg with cherry tomatoes, eggs from the allotment. We have a chicken keeper. That is lovely. And do they give out the eggs for free or? Oh, that is so, so cool. There are chickens on the allotment then? I'm just toying with things here. Just toying with things. Right, let's get this bolt back then. I ideally want it in there, but... No, we have to get it in there. Kiki is defeat, so I can't go through here because I'll die. Skull is hot. Bolt is melt, but Bubba's not melt. But then I get trapped in there if I push that any further. Oh, this is a clever one, folks. £1.50 per half dozen, perfect. That's lovely. Okay. Okay, I think I've got it. I think I've got it, folks. So I can't go past there because Kiki's in the way. But you know who can go past there? Bolt. Bolt can. If I push Bolt like that, and then I don't move like this. There we go. And then I wait. There we go. And now I can move past, get the win out, wait for Bolt to come back, and then move like that. Like that. I always visit them. They're very curious and always come to greet you. I love chickens. I love chickens. I think they're very sweet. It's one of my many, like, in the future dreams. Sorry, I immediately got reminded of a song there and I went through the song in my head. I will have backyard chickens because I think they're very nice. Do they have like feed? Can you feed them as well, Tortle? That would be lovely. Genius, thank you very much, Rebecca. Rebecca, I saw you just start Bubba as you. I hope I'm being a good example here. Bubba as you and open, win, flag, key. Okay, we need to make Bubba is win this time round. So I forgot what I did last time round. And open. Did I do? Key is open. That doesn't seem right. You're being very brave. Very, very brave. Unfortunately not. I've heard you can keep chickens on non-grain diets. Chicken non-grain diet. It does look like you can. Is there a benefit to go grain-free? Maybe I should know about this from my nutrition lectures. And there will be healthier birds if you don't. Interesting stuff. You probably know more about why that's a good idea than I do. Key is open and... Okay, so that means that we can't do it the way that we did it before. This kills me, doesn't it? Yeah, that kills me. Okay. Let's think about it. I just thought it was interesting. I thought it was their diet. I thought so too. I guess I wonder if it's, you can do it in a cheaper way, maybe? Like doing it so you don't have to, I'm stuck here. You don't have to feed them lots of grain and you can just use what you've produced as well, maybe? Perhaps is the way. Okay, right. Flag, key, Bubba is you, and open. Key is open. So we can make key is you and open, which is fine. Can't do it this way, though. These levels are always tougher, these, like... So, if I did and open, I could get to win, but I'd die. Water stops, so that doesn't go through. Okay. Here's you. Flag is you. Bubba is you. Bubba is me. There are lots of different types of chickens you can get as well. I actually had an exam on different types of chickens in my first year, which seems like a long while ago now. Bubba is you and open. Well, okay. Well, we're not going to get anywhere without some experimentation, right? Key is flag. And then we can go flag is you. Okay. And we could do Bubba and flag is you. Can we do that? We could do that. Okay. Okay. Oh, we're so screwed. Okay. No, that's not what we need to do. Mahjong, spread the knowledge. Yes. Yes, Lenimo. I am so pleased about that. A full-on presentation about Richie Mahjong, and I will do it. Thank you very much. I will let you all know when the presentations are coming. I promise you they are on their way. I'm still enjoying them. Don't worry about it. I will be doing them. That's very exciting. Thank you very much, Lelamo. That is, in fact, the Red Dragon. Yes. Let's knock that out. Flag is you and open. Let's try that. That's step one. Lelamo, the document that you you gave about... What have I done? About Richie Mahjong is so useful. So useful for me. I think I can do that. I think that'll be a very fun presentation. As a note, folks, if you did want a mini presentation, they are still able to be redeemed, so please feel free to do so. Flag is you and open. Let's get rid of that. Let's make Bubba is me again. Bubba is me. Ah! Don't do that. Can we do something like... Key and... Flag and Bubba is you. Does make it difficult, doesn't it? Oh, I accidentally pushed down too much. Bubba and flag is you would work. But that doesn't solve our problem. Oh, hold on. I got it. I think I've got it. I say it with such confidence, like, this is it, this is the one. Okay. Okay, now push down and we will become Bubba once more. Bubba become flag or whatever. Okay, then we need to get We need to get flag further around. Hold on, hold on. Sorry, Bubba. We need to come all the way around. Oh no. No, that's us screwed if we do that. Hold on then. Ah, Bubba, no! Ah, here we go. This is how we do it. Go, Bubba is you. Move that up, up, up. Out the way. Flag is open and win. Can we do that? Just to have flag as key and win. Doesn't matter what we have it as. This is fine, this is fine, this is fine. Maybe. No, because it's... We need to have it open and win. So we need open up there, which is tough because we got open down at the bottom. Okay, the last thing we want is open at the bottom. So can we keep it? Can we do everything that we do? There, where did we go? Okay, nice. Now it's easy. Now we just push up there. Put Bubba in charge. Put Bubba in charge. Okay, there we go. Folks, I think we're rocking and rolling. Is. And open out of the way. And in there. Open. I'm very pleased with this one, I'm going to be honest with you. I feel like this has been the most thinking I've done for one of the puzzles and actually worked it out and got it quite effectively. Very pleased with that. Right, wireless connection. Hello, Lewis. Well, not Lewis. Welcome on in. How are you doing today? Lovely to have you in here. I'm glad that you're patting Marley in celebration of me solving that level. So, on this side, folks, we've got pipe is stop, Bubba is you, flag is flag, bog is defeat. Bog is not defeat, bog is win. Bog together win. Then on that side, we've got flag rock win. I would be curious to reinstall this just to see how far I got. How far you got previously, Lelimo? I would be also curious to know. Cog is stop. Cog is not stop. Cog is, robot is push. What is this? Bog, that's bog. Bog is defeat. Robot is move. Is push and move. Cog is stop. Ah, stop. How am I to get robots to take up? Bubba is you, Piper stop. Those island puzzles are hard, like the little off, like the when you've done it and you go on further. Yeah, I agree, Grin. It is very, very tough. I like it though, it feels good when you get it. That one felt incredible, I'll be honest. Lovely to have you in here as well. Robot is push and move, cog is stop. So cog. Can we move Cog into a position and then get it to block Robot or something? Is that the intention? Cog is stop, so sorry, I can't push it. Hold on, pal, jeez. Robot is cog and push. I don't know about this one. Okay, let's see what we've got. Let's just take another look. Piper's stop. Fine, Piper's stop, that's okay. Bubba is you, that's something that is definitive. Flag is always going to be flag. Flag is rock and win. No. Cog is stop. We could use robot to push things in there, right? But then when we've got it in there, it wouldn't work. Cog is move. Flag is rock and win. That would mean that. Does it work that way around? Flag is rock and win. Would that remove the possibility to win because flag is no longer flag? Let's test. We're testing. This is just a test. Okay, hold on. Flag can't be rock, but can it be win? Is that what it's telling us? So cog is push. Cog is push. And we get and into position. I hope it doesn't cancel everything for us. Okay. Cog is move now. Take it in there, pal. Take it in. I shouldn't have done that. I shouldn't have done that. There we go. Flag is win. There we go. Look at that. I'm out of the lake. Brilliant stuff, Rebecca. Brilliant stuff. I knew you could do it, Rebecca. On to the next one, maybe? Level Island 11 Prison. Right, here we go. Baba is you. Kiki push, wall of stop, win. Huh? What? Well, the only thing we can do is Kiki is push. So Kiki's push now. But wall is stop. Kiki is wall. Baba is... Wall is you. Wall is you. No, we couldn't do that. Kiki is push. Wall is stop. I do not want to be where you are, though. I'm scared. It is frightening. It is frightening. Kiki is push. Baba is you. Wall is stop. Wind's outside. Can Kiki go through walls? Kiki is wall. Wall is Kiki. We'll just try it. We'll just try it. No, we won't. We can't try it. That'll get rid of Bubba. Kiki is push. This is a prison. Kiki is push, Bubba is you. Win, wall is stop. Wall is stop. We need to wall not stop. Kiki's push. Wall is Kiki. Wall is stop. Baba is incarcerated. Baba is committing crimes. Baba is serial killer. Kiki is push. Baba is you. Who is Wallace and why are they being told to stop? Wallace, stop. Welcome in, Tom Hoop. Lovely to have you in here. They are in jail. It's a necessary decision to make. There we go. Welcome in. Kiki is Kiki, that is very correct. Baba was put in prison for breaking the rules, quite literally breaking the rules. Baba is you. Baba is Kiki would kill us. That would kill us. Just check. We're dead. Baba is push would kill us. Kiki is you. Oh, I could do Kiki as you, that would work. But that doesn't help us. Doesn't help us in the slightest. Kiki is Baba. No. Kiki is push. Baba is push. Ah, stop. It's got me to a different position where I'm now Kiki, and Kiki is now incarcerated. Baba's push. Can just push Bubba about for a bit. Kiki is push, is you. Bubba is push. Wall is stop. So we need to get something down there to make wall not stop. But how can we make... What was the name of this level? Prison. That's it. Rules, Kiki is you, wall is stop, Babar is push. We can't break this up. Wall is stop. If we push this up, there's nothing to it. If we push it down, there's nothing to it. Can we make Baba? There must be something I'm missing here, folks. There must be something I'm missing. Kiki push, Baba is you. So the cross method didn't work. Push. Pus shop. Wall is pus shop. Kiki. I can't move any of this down because I'd die. But even if I wanted to have like something is wall, I couldn't do that. Kiki is. Wallace stop. Kiki is doesn't do anything. Baba is you. Kiki is you. Baba is you. I'm missing something here, folks. I am missing something here. Let's take a quick moment to ponder it. Baba is you. Win is outside. We can't go outside. Wall is stop. We don't want wall to be stop. We want wall to be not stop. Win is outside. Can we... That stops, yeah. Is there something that isn't real here? Wall is stop. Wall is stop. And I can't pull it down either. I can't do you is wall, because that doesn't work. Pushes Kiki. Let's just try it, just for curiosity's sake. Okay, it doesn't work. Kiki is push. Kiki's gonna have to be pushed. It doesn't matter if Baba's push or if Kiki is push. Something's push and it's... It's Kiki in this instance. So what can Kiki push? Kiki can't push is. Can't push wall. Pardon me. Can't push stop. We can say that Kiki is Kiki, but that doesn't do anything for us, does it? Kiki is Kiki. That's fine. That's fine. Baba is Kiki, will kill us. We're dead. I need to get... I think Kiki's stuck in there now, so let's solve that issue by doing this. There we go. Okay, let's try this. Doesn't do anything for us, fine. Did Kiki just go behind push there? Yes, Kiki did go behind push. And I got Kiki stuck behind push, like this. But then it isn't permanent. And then, I can't get Kiki out. Wall is stop. Can you push wall is stop up and down? I can push it down once, or I can push it up once. That's it. Did Kiki just go behind push there? I feel like that's a clue, Tortle. I feel like you've done something there. Wall is stop. Wall is stop is what we need to get rid of. Wall is stop. Kiki is push. Push can't go anywhere. Kiki is trapped. Kiki's now incarcerated. Kiki is you? Can we do that? Ah, no. I was wondering if I could then walk through things and like push. Peculiar. If Kiki can sit on top of words, can you put Kiki on stop and then become Kiki to move the other two? So no, I can't. So in theory that would work, but because Kiki can only go on top of words when you're not in push form, so I can push Kiki here. Maybe I can. Maybe this is what I'm missing. But then I can't push Kiki now. Can I push and push Kiki? No, it just traps Kiki. And then that's where I get stuck. I can't. What if you leave Kiki under push and push wall is stop on top of Kiki? Oh, very good. Very good. Yes, yes, that must be it. Hold on. So let's do Kiki is push and then we push. Ah, right. So we need to go back even further. Maz, you are the only person that can work with me on this and I love it. Just you and I here. There we go. Okay, so wall is stop. So we need to get push back even further. Come on. Get back. There we go, there we go. Okay, so Kiki is push. Teamwork. Total sentence is what gave me the idea. Yeah. Total. One thing that you always do well is give wonderful hints. There we go. Kiki is you. There we go. Yeah, your hints are not so obvious, but enough to prompt ideas. You've always done it with the FMs as well. I can't speak about solutions. I'm poisoned by knowledge. Grin, that is a statement. That is a statement and a half. Right, let's do these extra bits here. Dim signal. Let's see what this is. Flag is rock and ice and wind. Right? That can't be too hard. Oh, we need to then take something else across. Okay, I think the way to do it... No, I don't know. I remember nothing about this game and can only provide misdirection. Perfect, Lelimo. Between all of us, we're going to have like a fully functioning and dysfunctioning unit, which is ideal, if you ask me. This is where I started doing screenshot with marker edits. I see. I would love to see those at one point, Tortal, if that's okay. Just out of curiosity, right? So, and win. We need to get and in place. Trouble is, okay. Okay, here's my thinking, folks. Take a look at the other side as well. Barbara is you, flag is flag, pipe is stop, bog is defeat. Me. Flag, rock, ice, win. You can overlay grid lines. Hello? Like, you put your grid lines on top. That's what you've done. Or there's an actual way in the game. Settings, okay. Enable grid. Okay. So, my thoughts here, folks. We only have two things that can move. We've got cog and we've got robots. Flag flag is rock and ice and wind. We could use the flag to move. No? No. No, we couldn't. I'm not switching game already over here. Everything's fine. Rebecca, we won't mention it. We won't mention it. Cog. Cog is move. To be honest, I don't blame if anybody watching is switching game, because this is me just going, cog is move. Like, I'd be changing Baba as you immediately. But I'm loving this. I'm loving this. Don't get me wrong. Baba is you. Flag is flag. Piper stop. Bog is defeat. Flag, rock, ice, win. Cog is move. I think I might have it, folks. I think I might have it. Bear with me here. Bear with me here. So, we're gonna get robot in position. And we're going to make robot move. I think I have it. So, we're gonna get robot to move. Not that much. Not that much. Come back, pal. So my thought is, if I can pack something in there, so robot's there now. Now robot is irrelevant. We don't need robot anymore. We need cog. So robot is gonna be used as padding. And so is... we put like, stop. Can stop be used as padding? Okay, those two can be used as padding, and then we're gonna put an and in as well. So you see on the right-hand side of the screen here, there are three grids, and we need and to be underneath rock and above ice. So stop and robot are going on the side. Cog needs to move, because that's what we're actually moving. But we need to push cog first, because we need it to be in position. So cog is push. Like that, but we also need it to be in a particular position so it doesn't just move up. So, like this, right? Okay, bear with me, folks. I think I've got this. Two, okay, let's get into position. It shouldn't matter. We should be able to, there we go. Now cog has come back perfectly. And now we've got cog into push, and now we just get is, and we get is up here, get cog up there, put cog as move, get ready, and push. There we go, flag is win, we've won. There we go, look at that, that was very satisfying. Very, very satisfying. Talking through your thoughts keeps the stream interesting, thank you, Grin. I had heard of this game before, but had no idea what it was about. Looks very mentally stimulating. It feels incredible when you get these right. Like, it feels great. Who do you think you are? I am. I am. Right, let's go on to dungeon. Did I not just really struggle? That was jail. Now we're in dungeon. Okay. Kiki is all we get, folks. Kiki is. So we solved it by having Kiki as push before. Now we've got Kiki is us. Can I do that? Ooh, that makes it difficult. So we need Kiki down here, but we also need Bubba down there. Aha. There we go. Right? This has got to be it. I don't know how it's gonna work, but we're at least moving things down. Hold on, I've completely forgotten why I'm doing this. I need to somehow displace. Okay. So, we can get Bubba is, or Kiki is, set up like this. Well, we need to get everything down first. Hold on, folks. Bubba is you, Kiki is you. Okay, Bubba is you. Let's get Kiki is there. Let's get Bubba is there. Oh, I've botched something. We need Kiki to be me beforehand. I thought you were gonna make an L shape with Kiki as you, Bubba as you, but this is more fun. I think I need to do this. Oh, you know what? That might be a good idea. Let's see what we can do with this, though. Bubba is you. That might be what we need to do. Bubba is you. Right, so we need Bubba to be over there. I think that might be the solution. Bubba is, because I can't get. Bubba locked in there. Yeah, no, I can't get Bubba locked in there. Let's try that again. This is a nice idea. Nice idea. So, let's use, it's like the cross method. I also do want it down, just because it's nice to have it in the middle, isn't it? Kiki is you. Right, now let's, not that far, get it like that. Okay, so now we both are, oh, we're stuck there. No, terrible idea. Okay. This is a puzzling one, folks, but I think we can do it. My thoughts are we need to get closer. Again. We need to get closer again so that Kiki or Bubba can just knock. Oh, that wasn't what I wanted to do. Can just knock the other out quickly. One needs to be lodged in that corner there. That's troublesome. Can we switch your angles, pals? Like, one of you is down here. Bubba, let's tuck you in there. Oh. No, that wasn't what we wanted. Bubba, did we make Bubba as Kiki? We don't want that. Hold on. Let's get Kiki out the way then. Can we push? Oh, flip. Whenever they gave me the same puzzle with a slightly different solution, I started to cry inside. Yeah, these like island ones are tough. We must be getting close, right? Yes. Kiki. Oh, wait, no. Kiki is me still. Hold on. Kiki, stop. Hold on. Go back. Wall. Oh, wall's not stopped. I can push. It doesn't even matter. Wall is win. We've got it. Yes. It usually means the playtester solved a level in a way the creator hadn't expected, so he redesigned the level to stop that solution and designed another level to encourage the alternate solution. That's lovely. I love that as an idea. That's a very nice concept. That's fun. This feels right. Yeah, yeah. I was worried that it wasn't going to work there. Oh, oh. Right, so, folks, Bubba is you. Flag, death, 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 is win. Water is sink, wall is stop. Cog is push and melt, skull is defeat. Water is hot. Bubba... can walk across water. Water is hot. Wall is stop. Flag. Cog is push and melt. So cog is melt. Water is sink. Wall is stop. Cog is sink. Can we make cog is sink? Does that do anything for us? We're just taking it across here for the fun of it. Let's see what happens. Cog is sink. Okay, jeez, pal. Come on. Okay, we've got cog stuck there. One sec. Oh, I'm so silly. I could just do this. Okay. Maybe that's good? Somewhere on the internet, I'm sure they'd say Bubba is hot. I'm sure they would. I'm sure they would. I don't think I want to Google that right now, Lelimo. But I'm curious all the same. Okay. Pog is water. I mean, there is no cog left. Wall. Flag is water. No. We don't want that. Cog is push. Water is sink. I don't remember how we solved this one in the first place, and I don't know if that's more beneficial to not know or to know. We need to get something to... hold on. Hold on. Have we got it? We need something else. Oh. Hold on. We didn't need to do any of this. Oh, we do. We do need to do it. Because we need cog to push. What just happened? What just happened there? Okay. Water sink to push flag into place. Yeah, that's what I was thinking, but I need one extra, right? I need one more letter. So if we had cog, it would be fine, but... cog is sink. Doesn't help us because we get rid of cog that way. We're working this out, folks. We're getting there. Cog is push and melt. Skull is defeat. Is sink. So, okay. Hear me out on this one, folks. Over on this side, we have flag behind three skulls. Now, my thinking is... flag is sink. My thinking is, I needed one more thing to push it so flag is win. But what is that one thing? Because Bubba's defeat. Skull is defeat, Bubba. Bubba is you. Hello, Gigasilas. Welcome on in. How are you doing, pal? We're puzzling out Bubba is you. Why did flag kill me? Did I sink? Water is sink. Water is not sink. Water is hot. Flag is sink. Which is Baba is kill. Let's take it back now, y'all. Just out of curiosity. Water is sink. Wall is stop. We could do water is wall. Water is wall would not help us. Wall is stop. I'm stuck. Just curious. Not bad, how are you? I'm doing wonderfully, thank you. This has been a very fun stream for me, so I'm having a great time. Okay, water is sink, so I'm fine. Cog is push and melt. Can we make cog not melt? Water is water. Cog is water? No. I would still like you to see you try the witness one day. Don't you worry, Lelamo. I have not forgotten at all. I have not forgotten. And I would like to show you me what do with if water is witness. You know? I will do it at some point. I'm a slow gamer, as you have definitely noticed. I take my time with everything. But I will do it. I was discussing this with Portal yesterday as well. I take things slowly. Bubba is you, flag. I'm back in the position that I was in just moments ago. Which is where I have 3, which is not 4. Flag is think, which kills me. Also Oberdin, also Outer Wilds, also so. Hey, Outer Wilds, I'm doing that. I'm getting to it, and I'm enjoying it thoroughly. Oberdin, you want everyone to do Oberdin, Lelamo. Not just me. I'm not the special one here. Die, not die. Flag is sink. Flag is win is what we want. Okay, we've got everything back alive again. And cog push flag. Why did that happen then? Wait is spacebar. Water is defeat. Just testing it. Water is water. It's because, just like Outer Wilds, it's one of those games you can't really play again after the first time. Use the cog to break the skull, then, maybe? Oh, what? So... No, because we need cog... we can get cog across, can't we? How did sink... We had it so sink destroyed things, didn't we? But then I think it doesn't solve it still, because then we lose 2 items, Maz. Did sink not destroy things for a moment? That's not what we want. I'm sure sink destroyed things. I do have fewer skulls to get through, but I also have fewer words to get through the skulls, if that makes sense. Because if I push the cog destroys. So look, it would destroy it. I've forgotten what I did. Cog is sink, which destroys the cog and the water. Fine. Can I slide everything into place a different way? No. We'll think about that in a sec. So my only joy is watching other people do it. Yes, I will. I will definitely do it. Feel Elmo. Water is... Oh, ooh, ah, ah, ooh, ooh. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Hold on. This, I don't know what I'm doing. This won't help me in the slightest. Water is skull, but skull is defeat, so I'm in trouble. Why did I do that? You pushed the cog into the flag and it sunk the flag, is that right? So I put cog as sink and then... Cool, thank you. Thank you. So then... But did I also not have... I definitely had... I pushed sink in earlier. I could clip myself doing this and I could see where I did it. I pushed sink into... here and it sunk. Do I watch my VOD back? Because now that melts. Because it was still water as sink. Oh, so I had it that way round, right. Let's do it this way. Okay, water is... sink. Fair play. I'll give them that. Water is sink. Then push up, up, up. So there we go. That's where we got to. And then we can get cog is sink. Is this what you were talking about here, Naz? Getting cog is sink to destroy the... Help. What am I doing? Cog is... sink. So that'll destroy one of the skulls. And then we're still left with two skulls. Which is a problem because we've only got is sink now. And we're stuck. Which is the problem. So that's what I mean. Having fewer skulls is not a solution when we don't have the way to get through the skulls. Unless... No. We're still stuck with... Yeah. Yeah, you see my point? Ravenstone, thank you very much for the follow. Welcome on in, pal. Wait, push water as sink as a sentence into the water and then cog as sink? Yes. And then you have less skulls, yes. But it works in theory, but not in practice. Which is a shame. Bubba is you. Flag is sink, we don't want that. Cog. Oh, hold on, I've got it. We just needed to get through one of the skulls. All that mattered was getting through one of the skulls. The other two are completely irrelevant. It was just that one that we needed to get through. There we go. Lovely, lovely stuff. Right, that is two levels of Bubba as You fully completed. I'm very pleased with that. What is next? We've got Temple Ruins. Okay, Temple Ruins will be the one for next time. It'll be the one for next time. Oh, well, exactly, Maz. This game is so rude that way. Maz, I'll have to get you on stream to talk through it with me. I would love that. That would be great. Ravenstone, I agree, but it's so, so fun in that way, isn't it? Like, it tells you what you need to do. The information's all there for you. It's just about if you read it and understand it. So my main issue with this game was thinking I had a solution and spending ages on it, but it was an alternative thing I hadn't considered. So you had that solution and you kept working towards it, but it wasn't even close to the end. I think I'm getting lucky, and there'll be one that I bump into and I'll be like, this is terrible, and I get it wrong for ages. Me with any puzzle, I'm stubborn. I'm probably quite stubborn as well. Yeah, that's why I think doing it with another person is quite useful. But yeah, thoroughly enjoying this. I will finish this game. I've done it now. I will finish this game. I've got past the first two levels, which I'm pleased about. Thank you very much, Grin. Very, very nice to have you along for today. I have had a wonderful stream, everyone, so I hope you have as well. And I hope you wouldn't mind if I send you on somewhere now to see the rest of the day through. I hope that's okay. And I know just the place for it. Such a fun stream, Mono. Will Volpec play us out? Oh, Tortle. You're tempting fate here, pal, he says, closing the tab as he begins to open Volpec. What are we feeling? We have to go. Okay, here we go. This is what we're going for. Thank you, everyone, for being here. Don't leave us. SK, I have to go. But don't worry. Even though I'm leaving you, there are other people that I can send you to. And you're going to be very pleased with it. This is Disco Ulysses by Volpec, if anyone's curious. Very, very good. Very, very good. Thank you, everyone, for being here. We're going to raid on to Hobbitan. Please give Hobbitan all the love. They're wonderful. They're really, really wonderful. And you'll enjoy your time with them. Thank you for a very fun stream, everyone. It's been very, very fun. Thank you, Ree. Thank you, Ange, Maz, Tortle, Gig Silas, SK, Lassie, Adam First. Brilliant. Lovely to have you here. Rebecca Ree, this has been one of my favorite streams ever. Thank you so much for a lovely morning. I love it when I get the chance to just chat aimlessly for ages. So thank you all for letting me do that for so long. Like 2 hours of just me babbling about stuff. Really appreciating it. Every time I've checked your Spotify activity, it's been Volpec or Volpec adjacent, and it will continue to be, Lelimo, it will continue to be. Lots of love to you all. I will catch you again soon. Have a wonderful day. Give lots of love to Hobbitan. And I'll catch you soon. Goodbye, everyone. Goodbye, goodbye, farewell, goodbye. So good. Hear that bass. Give my love to Hobbitan. Goodbye.